Opening faceoff, Capitals and Flyers, Game 7. This is all there is. There isn't any more. And for the winner, the New Jersey Devils await. You know, the Washington Capitals, without doubt, one of the most puzzling teams in all the National Hockey League. Loaded with talent and that magic word potential for the last few years, the Capitals have never lived up to that potential or talent. They have never, ever gone past the divisional finals in the tough Patrick Division. Could this be the year, or will the Capitals lose Game 7 tonight, and will the question marks remain? And if they lose Game 7, will head coach Brian Murray remain behind the bench in Landover, Maryland? Well, we spoke to Brian Murray about this Washington Capitals team. He says this team this year is different from past teams, has a lot more character, and he says that this year he knew that the Washington Capitals players were capable of something special in the playoffs.
The way all of our players are playing so disciplined and trying to do things, and the goaltending of Pete Peters right now is really sound. And we have everybody healthy going into the final game, and I think that was the bottom line. If we'd have been healthy the last time in here, I think it would have been over tonight, but unfortunately we do have to play a seventh game, but maybe fortunately we have to play because our players have come a long ways, and maybe now some of the people will believe that there is a lot of character and a great deal of heart in this team.
Well, the Washington goaltending is healthy. The Flyer goaltending is healthy in body. You have to wonder about the psyche, though, of Ron Hextall. That still is the big question in my mind coming into this seventh game. Let's go live for the opening faceoff now to Bill Clement and Mike Emmert.
Thank you, Tom. The troubleshooter, Don Koharski, who has had a lot of the significant playoff games in the last 2 years, is the referee. Rob Finn and Bob Hodges are the linesmen. Ron Hextall in goal. He has been everything in the past, but this year it has been difficult. There's a guy who was so strong with Boston in some key playoff games, and sometimes that gets forgotten. But against the Philadelphia Flyers this season, he has not done that well, except at playoff time. Sutter, Brown, and Derek Smith. Sundstrom, Corriveau, and Hunter. Those are the starting lines. Samuelson and Howe on defense for Philadelphia. Hatcher and Langley for Washington. The first dump is to Hextall. Derek Smith tips it back, and it moves in on Pete Peters. Peters swings it. It's tipped by Hatcher, stopped by Markow. Tried to shovel ahead, but it's forced deeper by Corriveau. Shell Samuelson drills one that goes by Brown, and Scott Stevens must chase.
You know, I have to agree with what Tom said before the game. Ron Hextall is on an emotional, mental teeter-totter right now. The first few shots that he faces will be crucial to his performance tonight.
It is Dave Brown to Derek Smith, and it's tipped back. Striding back for this is the captain of Philadelphia, Dave Poulin. Galley able to brush it along to Scott Stevens. Two men there, Poulin and Stevens, on the ice together, who have had heroic roles for their teams. Poulin last year, Game 7 against the Islanders, playing with broken ribs. And Scott Stevens coming in to play the fifth game here, despite a shoulder injury to the right side. Here is Brad Marsh with a shot that ricocheted off Galley. Turning for it is Stevens. After him is Poulin. The puck forced further by Tockett. Hammers one, and that one went around and past Marsh and down. Turned over to Doug Crossman. Banked further, but that one knocked away by Ledyard, and then he's hit by Tockett, and his helmet pops off. On with it is Pavanka for a shot that's tipped wide. Overskated, and a shot in front is blocked off by Brad Marsh from Christian. Ledyard drops it back in. Another rare sort of mistake for Hextall in trying to handle that puck. Kelly Miller burrows in. Hextall out to play it, pokes it free. Zezel turns it along to Cinisano. Hit by Ledyard. The play comes to Kravis. One-on-one against Murphy, and a shot casually saved. Rebound came right in as Peters stood tall and got the pad on it. Now Cinisano to Howe, a shot. That one caught the outside of the goal on the post. Howe hit hard on the play by Larry Murphy. Stoppage as the puck was frozen. And we'll get a face-off in the Washington end.
You know, the sign of whether or not these teams are ready to play, especially the Flyers, is are they making contact? Well, I'll tell you something. The Flyers have established their forechecking game early. They are in there banging people. Obviously, the Flyers are not going to go out with a whimper. People might think, hey, last game they lost 7-2 at home. Forget about it. It is a proud team. This will be a real clash tonight.
You see some of the numbers pertinent to the series. Tim Kerr will take the faceoff for Philadelphia. Kerr is in his sixth game. This the seventh one of the series. He has no goals. Hatcher in, drives it away from Kerr. It's popped further by Bobby Gould. Gould has applied real back-breaking goals. Two shorthanded in the last two games for Washington. Penalty away from the puck. High sticking is the call, and the first man to go to the penalty box will be Shel Samuelson. Washington will have a power play, and Dale Hunter, is it, or is it Greg Adams? It is Adams. No score, first period.
There's number 22, Greg Adams, who was just helped off the ice. He was high-sticked by Shel Samuelson. It did not escape the eye of Don Kuharsky. So the Capitals, who have been red hot, they struggled all season long in the power play. Well, if you're going to get your power play together, now is the right time. Four power play goals in game six in Philadelphia, and that's 7-2 victory. So we'll see if the heat carries over.
Overall in the series, they are 7-39 on the man advantage. Many of the fans here are wearing white, and they are also waving white tonight. They've been outfitted with white shakers, similar to what New Jersey fans had in their first home game of their series. Poulin shorthandedly drives one that is tipped to the seats by Pete Peters.
Boy, his confidence has come on, Pete Peters has, as this series has gone on, and we've talked about Pete not having the reputation of being able to win the big games. He has gone miles and miles to shaking that monkey that's been on his back. And tonight is the night that he can finally, I think, rip it off and throw it someplace else.
Saw two Caps fans in the hallway. One of them said to the other, within my earshot, tonight the label changes. That's a story not only for Pete, but for this team.
Well, we said that when the Capitals were down 3-1. They set it up, although it was hardly intentional. They set up a situation where they could shake all of those negative labels that have been surrounding them for so many years. And now they're finally here. This is it. Game seven.
Larry Murphy. The play is out to Hunter. And Dale Hunter just lobs. He and Crossman turn to play it. Hunter centers. Poulin is right there and clears.
You know, the longer this game goes on, with Ron Hextall not really being tested, the more confidence he's going to have. His guys have really given him a lot of protection. He hasn't even faced a shot yet.
Neither team with a shot, but then Gartner's bullet went off Marsh's stick and ricocheted wide. Staggering is Ridley. The puck played by Hunter out to Murphy, and it kicked off him and must be taken by Stevens. The Caps must regroup at center ice. Larry Murphy's pass is to Gartner. Feathers one back to Stevens. Stevens eyed by Tockett, the play to Gartner, but it is drilled back down by Brad Marsh. Halfway through the power play, 16:20 to go, first period, no score. Game seven, best of seven, between the Philadelphia Flyers and the Washington Capitals. Stevens pass, slowed by Gustafson, taken by Christian, and Christian swirls, rolls one across the goal mouth wide. Sinisalo tried to clear. We get a stoppage of play as the net has become dislodged, and Don Kuharsky points the faceoff back out of the zone.
Well, I'll tell you, Hextall is not shy to challenge. Here he is. Watch Dave Christian go around Brad Marsh. Hextall all the way out. That's a real good read by Hextall. He knows that he has Doug Crossman right there in front, number three. He has no Capitals barreling in, so do what he does best. Still be aggressive. Get out there and challenge.
Past history has shown that teams like to keep the puck away from Ron Hextall. Do we anticipate that that would change tonight or not?
I'm going to try and watch for it. I think that if a goaltender is struggling, all parts of his game fall apart. And I think Washington might feel that way as well. But if you end up giving him the puck too often and realizing that his game hasn't fallen apart, then he is back and he has been able to shake off the effects of subpar games 5 and 6, then where are you? Then you're playing right into his strength. I think Washington will probably continue to try and keep the puck away from him.
8 seconds left, power play. Kovanka moving in. Puck banked around. To take it is Kevin Hatcher. Out of the box, Samuelson. Hatcher's drive goes wide. Galley there had it tipped away by Poulin. Back to get it is Bent Gustafson for the Capitals. No score, 15:20 to go, first period. Teams at full strength. And Hatcher lobs, forcing Crossman to chase. The defense for Philadelphia is Crossman along with Howe. Tim Kerr is up front. Scott Mellenby is there, and Derek Smith. Capitals retrieve, and it is Ledyard banking one along to Rod Langway, who missed two games in this series. Gould off Ledyard, sized up by Marsh and checked. In deep is Leach. He's hit by Greg Smith. Two aside work. Capitals fans want a penalty. Ledyard banks. It's taken by Leach. Fended Gould, and he hurried a shot wide. It was tipped after he let it go. And the Flyers are able to toss it out of play, so we have the clock stopped with 14:41 to go in the first. No score. This is the road to the Stanley Cup on ESPN. Tom Mees back at our studios. For a change, he doesn't have other games to watch tonight, but he'll be reporting to you between periods, along with Bill Clement, Mike Emmerich from Capital Center in Landover. No score, first period. Philadelphia and Washington, as a centering pass for Kelly Miller was disrupted because of Samuelson's checking. Ahead with this is Zettel, drops it off to Mark Howe. Then to Shel Samuelson. A pass for Craven was tipped away by Gartner. Galley back, checked by Craven, but the puck rolled along near Scott Stevens, who throws Zettel out of the play. Guided back up by Sinisalo, followed up by Stevens, gets away from the front of the Zettel check. Craven rammed into Kelly Miller, and Craven went down. We get a frozen puck and a stoppage of play.
Well, Don Koharski had a real good view of that action. He was about 8 feet away. Tonight, what do you see? You see two teams very well prepared to play this hockey game. In game five, we were here, and we saw the Flyers with the chance to deliver the knockout punch. Langway was hurt, and Scott Stevens was on the limp, but he was in uniform, and the Flyers really didn't play the physical style that they've become known for. Well, tonight they are. Washington is dishing it right back. This looks like a battle. So far, the variable we are not sure of, Ron Hextall. Is he on top of his game? A couple of times the Capitals have had a chance to just get a shot on net, and they shot wide. We don't know yet.
Gustafson pass back, checked away by Poulin and dropped in by Propp. First one there, Tocchet drills it wide. Around it comes to Brian Propp. Centered one, and that one chipped away. Moving forward is Crossman. Poulin in front wants it. The puck flipped over the glass. And so again, a face-off to result, and this time in the Capitals' end of the ice. Yeah, he got it. I'm not sure how difficult this decision on goaltender really was. Mike Keenan said earlier in the series, I declare a number one goaltender and I go with it.
I don't think it was a difficult decision for him at all. He didn't tell everybody, so a lot of people can speculate as to the difficulty of it, but he is his man. Ron Hextall is Mike Keenan's man. But you know, that brings up an interesting point. If you live by the one goalie system, sometimes you die by it. Same as the two goalie system. You live by it and you die by it. I don't think there is one system better than the other. It's whichever one works. But you can see the problems of a one goalie system. When your goalie gets cold, what do you do when your backup hasn't played a lot and is not used to big hockey games? Then you're in trouble when you use a one-goalie system.
Hunter lost. And so Howe and Samuelson, 2 and 28, turn to chase. Samuelson trying to wedge it away from Christian and is able to play it back in. Pete Peters sets it up for Rod Langway. Langway's pass missed for Hunter and is corralled by Samuelson. 13 minutes, 10 seconds to go, first period of play. The puck dumped to the Poulin corner, but there first is Hatcher. Ripped back along to Christian. Outlet pass to Gustafson. Up the wing, but it's back checked away from Pavanga.
Good defensive play by Brian Propp. He knew he was beat to the outside. He just dropped his stick behind him and cut the pass blind.
Hatcher angles, and Howe will chase. This will be an icing call. Clock stop, 12:47 to go in the first period. We have no score. The first goal scorer in each of the previous six games has been the winning team at the end of the night. And you can talk about all of these unusual things all you want, and it doesn't mean a darn thing. Sutter and Hunter, two strong nominees for our Junkyard Dog team, have drawn, and Grant Ledyard is up with it. Flicks to Hunter. It's tapped on over for the throw-in by Corvo. Wedged off by Marsh. Hextall able to spin it along. Off the glove of Sundstrom. Back to Murphy for a shot. That one slowed. Poked away, and Sundstrom falls trying to get it. Hunter forges it behind, but it's ripped back along by Hextall. Dave Brown can't play. Murphy drops it back in, and so Brad Marsh will turn. He's matched up with Greg Smith on defense. Marsh saw Corvo follow through on his check after he passed across. This is Dave Brown. Has Sutter moving and gives to him. Sutter plays it across. Marsh got a shot in on goal, and that's swept aside by Peters. Backhand attempt by Derek Smith, foiled by Murphy. Ahead with it, the cap. Outlet passes to Sundstrom, trying to pull away. Backhander is directed wide. Play continues. Capitals fans upset that there was no penalty there. As the puck glanced all the way back down, there'll be no icing. Shift change on for both teams. A pass goes by Bobby Gould. And back to get this is Huffman. There will be icing on this play. The puck sent across both the center line and the end line. Some touch by the defensive team. Many of the fans here wearing white tonight and waving white, as we mentioned. 18,130 of them. That's capacity.
Here's the break by Peter Sundstrom. It was a two-line pass until one of the Flyers touched it on the way from the cap zone over two lines to Sundstrom. You can see Brad Marsh getting back, and you got a stick up under his arms. Once you get your stick right against somebody's chest and get it under that far arm, all you have to do is twist it a little bit, and you can see the results. Peter Sundstrom just twisted down onto the ice by Marsh.
Yesterday morning, the morning after Washington's six-game victory, there were 1,180 tickets left. The box office opened at 10. The 1,180 were gone in 12 minutes. Zezel for the faceoff opposite Hunter. Huffman and Crossman guarding the blue line for Philadelphia. Encroachment by Zezel. Ron Finn says leave. So it'll be Craven coming on. From the sticks being crossed, it's Scott Stevens. Stevens with a pass to Adams. Tried to hurry it along, but Sinisalo got in the way. Booming check by Stevens on Zezel. And Stevens able to steer it back up to Adams. A three-on-two developing. Bobby Gould back to Adams. Has a man breaking. Cross-ice pass to Galley, and he one-handed it wide. It looked like a setup that might not work, but Galley steamed in the right side and got a chance. On with it now is Graven. Craven tied up by Galley, centers one, and dropping to block that one away is Stevens. Gartner right back for Washington. Off the stick of Gould, it's fielded by Huffman. Dropped back to Stevens. Crossman must chase again, and the Caps take this opportunity to make a change. Moving in is Kelly Miller. Has been a thorn in the side of the Flyers through the whole series. This is Hatcher. Checked by Huffman. Hooked at by Huffman. Throws it in on goal, blocked off by Hextall. Behind they work. Backhand attempt knocked down. Crossman trying to out-wrestle Miller. Loose puck thrown away by Kerr, but there'll be a penalty coming up to Philadelphia. Washington will get its second power play midway in the first period. Scoreless right now.
The Capitals' pressure has been able to get them another power play here from behind Ron Hextall. There is Doug Crossman, and he is fighting with Kelly Miller. I think at right about this stage here is when Don Koharski picks it up, and you can see that Crossman just swung around and held Miller. So the faceoff is in the Flyers zone. Here's Washington on their second power play. Flyers did an outstanding job on the first one, killing it off.
Gustafson, Pavanka, and Christian, and the puck knocked down by Poulin and Propp. One of the premier duos in upfront penalty killing in the league. Now the two men in back will be the veterans, Samuelson and Howe. Hatcher will work one point. Gary Galley will work the other. Pavanka plays over to Christian. Has it knocked away by Howe and sped back out by Poulin. Turning is Hatcher. Loses to Propp. Sent ahead for Howe. Poked it through Gary Galley, but it is swung just wide of the net.
Wow.
By Gustafson.
He missed the short side high by inches.
Pete Peters was pointing to his stick right then. That didn't catch the stick of Peters, did it?
I don't think so, but I've seen guys aiming for the short side miss it by further than that. He was just trying to put it around the boards. Mark Howe had moved up ice. And it's, to me, it's apparent now that the Flyers are not going to lay back on their penalty killing. They are going to move up and try and force the issue every chance they get. Here's the difference between regular season and playoffs. You can see that those penalty totals are up for both teams. Part of it is because of the urgency of playoff games, but a big part of it is the fact that officials are calling these games the same from start to finish, tight.
Gary Frazier and Gord Brossaker are the backup officials tonight, the same two who were the backup officials a year ago tonight when we went to 1:55 in the morning. Puck tip over to Mark Howe. Howe has Poulin ahead, feeds from prop over to Poulin, and he just couldn't get by Larry Murphy. Murphy and Scott Stevens are in back now, halfway through the Washington power play. Murphy drops one off Hextall, out to swing it. Into the seats, it went over cleanly. What will be the call? A minor penalty. Fine.
You bet. You bet. He's out of here. What a key play. The puck was bouncing. Ron Hextall shot it into the stands. It didn't hit anything. He's out of here for 2 minutes. We'll see what the Capitals can do. Corliss.
Sold out Capitol Center, Landover, Maryland. Seventh game. Best of seven series. Series, of course, tied. This game tied. Along with Bill Clement and Tom Meese back at our studios, Mike Emery. They're waving white. The white team has the power play, and Stevens with a drive that ricocheted off the boards. It's worked back from Hunter to Murphy. Murphy in front to Ridley. Sets up Hunter in a short side attempt, tipped away by Hextall. Murphy spins it to Stevens. Back to Larry Murphy. In front, Hunter directs, and it's tipped away by Hextall. Pinching is Murphy. Looks towards Stevens and gives to him. Hatchet drive. It's blocked away by Samuelson. The 5-on-3 has 23 seconds. Murphy across. Save made by Hextall on Gartner. Incredible.
The more you watch, the more you have to think that number 27 right there, Ron Hextall, is back. He claims to be able to leave every game behind him. That hasn't been the case in this series, but watch this save. Mike Gartner didn't one time, and he had to stop it because he flipped up on edge. And the Flyers are doing an outstanding job at killing off a 5-on-3. Washington all over them. Look at Hextall move from one side of the net to the other. What a step the Flyers could take right here to getting some of that momentum back, to shifting. And Ron Hextall, he has created his own demon. He is the reason they are down two men. He shot the puck into the stands. Koharski saw him. For the Capitals, if they want to squash the Flyers, now is the time. They have a two-man advantage. This is a real key moment in this hockey game early.
18 seconds on the two-man advantage, and the Caps will lose some of that chasing. Larry Murphy, 10 seconds left on the 5-on-3. Speeds it on in. Has Christian floating up the wing, gives to Stevens. In front, the tip by Pavonka, saved by Hextall. Rebound to Murphy. Murphy finesses over for Christian. First man back on the ice. Christian's pass blocked off by Poulin. Forced behind, though. Pavonka gets it from Gustafson and returns. Pinching along is Stevens. Fires one that ricochets off the board. To get it is Larry Murphy. 50 seconds to go on the 5-on-4 power play. Christian is there. Duels with Shel Samuelson. Samuelson able to clear. Shift change. Brad Marsh comes out to join Samuelson in back. Ron Sutter working up front with Craven. Murphy and Stevens still the point men for Washington, and they bring it up ice. Mishandle, but Murphy is able to loft one off the glove of Sutter. At the line, Craven battles. Puck hand pass, and with that, we'll get a stoppage of play. And 21 seconds to go on the Capitals' remaining power play time.
Well, if I had to give Ron Hextall a report card right now, I'd have to give him an A+, and it's not because the Capitals haven't been able to score on him. I think they played their 5-on-3 reasonably well. Hextall's decisions have all been good. The last time the Capitals had a rush on the 5-on-3, they tried for a deflection in front. Hextall read it, moved out. He broke up the deflection in front of himself, by himself. His decisions have been strong.
Brian Murray, the coach of the Capitals, said this morning, he said, I'll use the word, people say that we've choked in the past. We can rewrite history. It's the type of opportunity, he said, that you dream of.
He has handled all the pressure pretty well, too. He has been under the gun for a couple of years here. Every year that the Capitals go without knocking off everybody in their division, people obviously look to the coach, they look to Brian Murray, and I'll tell you what, for a guy under the gun, he has held up very well. He has been a picture of stability here during all of the gunfire.
So also has the goaltender Pete Peters. Play develops near Mike Gartner. Gartner, the leading goal scorer this year with 48. Curls. Penalty time is up as he throws one near Brad Marsh. Hit hard by Miller. Gartner turns, Tockett there for Philadelphia. Gives it up to Ridley. Spun behind for Miller. Miller able to reach, but is chased off by Brad Marsh. Stoppage of play. And down on all fours is Mike Gartner. There'll be another Philadelphia penalty, and Ron Sutter is the man who will head to the box. Gartner appears shaky, but okay. 7:13 to go in the first period. It's still scoreless.
Without question, Don Koharski has his X-ray vision working tonight. He has whistled off Ron Sutter, and should the Flyers continue, they have to realize that they are playing with a loaded gun. It is pure fire. The Caps went 4-for-9 on the power play in Game 6 in Philadelphia two nights ago. And here, right about where the faceoff is taking place, you can see is where Ron Sutter took out Mike Gartner. Not a dangerous guy. He was all the way out of the zone, didn't even have the puck. The Flyers have to kill another one off.
12:47, elapsed time in the period when the penalty was called to Sutter for high sticking. Mark Howe lays it back over to Samuelson, who drills it back down. Now they'll use Murphy and Scott Stevens on the points again. Up front, the Caps have Pavonka along with Christian, and trailing all the way back at the Philadelphia line, out of your picture, is Gustafson. So they go with the same power play unit as before. In with it comes Christian. Pivots away. Looks back to Murphy, but gives in deep to Pavonka. They get crossed up. The puck to Propp, who clears. Critical point in the game Bill mentioned a moment ago, and you hear just a few boos from the fans. They've seen plenty of opportunity here, and thus far unrewarded. Play goes back over to Christian. Throws it in deep. Turning is Pavonka. Lays it back over for Christian. Checked on the play by Craven. Christian able to turn. Dips it off to Pavonka. Back along to Gustafson. Looks to Murphy, but controls himself. Then hands to Murphy. 50 seconds power play. They're keeping it to the outside. Gustafson threw it across the goal mouth wide. Scott Stevens on to Murphy. Backhands to Christian. Backhander kicked out by Hextall. Then covered. Stoppage of play.
Gustafson had a hold of Brad Marsh's stick in front of the net. Brad was yelling, "Let me go." What a key opportunity for the Capitals in this hockey game. Depending on how this game turns out, they might look back. Here's Ron Hextall holding his ground again. Looks pretty stable to me, but the Capitals have had their opportunities on the power play in this first period. Have to capitalize. If you were going to write a script for a hockey game, wouldn't you write it with you having three power plays in the first, 14 minutes of a hockey game? Sure you would. But then the next part of the script would have a scenario of you scoring on some of those power plays. That's something that the Capitals haven't done. See it down there in the bottom right? We're looking at an 0-for-3 situation for the Capitals. And the longer they go without scoring, I think the stronger the Flyers are going to get, especially given the fact that they are killing penalties here. Scoreless, if everybody is playing at even strength, isn't quite as important to the Flyers as them going into a locker room saying, "Boys, we had our backs to the wall, we killed all the penalties, Hextall is getting stronger, we're here, we're here."
Hextall slides it up to Poulin. And turning to play is Gary Galley. Flyers make one change. They bring Propp out to go along with Poulin. 27 seconds to go on the fourth Washington power play. Ahead with it comes Galley. Side by side with Hatcher. It bounced near Hextall. He corrals and flings it off. It sailed by Hunter and right to Dave Poulin, who charges out with it. Hands over to Propp. Propp up the wing. Galley moving on him. But all this time, power play time, is going off the board to the Capitals. 3 seconds and two as Hatcher hits center zone. Hatcher carries out of the box Sutter. The puck back to the blue line, but it was outside. And so when Galley brought it in, four of his teammates were in the zone, and we get an offside call.
I think we should point out as well that should the Flyers, well, they've killed off this one, so they've killed off all of the Washington power plays in the first period. That doesn't mean the Washington Capitals are going to shrivel up and die just because they didn't score in the power play. I was the guy that stood right up here about 10 feet from where I'm sitting with a fly swatter before the last game that we did here, saying this fly swatter is not nearly big enough because it said Flyer swatter on it. I said the Flyers are going to move and win this series tonight. Washington has really impressed me with their mental toughness, and I think they've shown a lot of people that there is probably more character on this Washington team than their history would indicate.
Good point, and that's a history that maybe we should document again if we get a moment. Puck dropped back out by Peter Zezel, brought along by Leach, broken up by Zezel. Without a stick, He controls and escapes and then hand passes it along, and that'll bring us a stoppage of play. In 1985, against the Islanders in a best of five, the Caps won the first two, lost the next three, and went out. In 1986, against the Rangers, the Caps led 2-1, lost three in a row, and went out. Last year against the Islanders, the Caps won three of the first four, lost three in a row, and went out. And that's when the choke label came.
Something about an extended overtime game here too, wasn't there?
Yes. A year ago tonight. And one of the men who had one of the better chances, Bobby Gould, has just won this faceoff to Ledyard. Wrapping it around, Crossman guides it back out. Captain Rod Langway scales it back in, and to get it is Howe from Hextall. 4 minutes, 35 seconds to go. First period, we have no score. Up the wing comes Derek Smith. Duels with Ledyard. Penalty coming up. It'll be on the Capitals. Philadelphia will get its first power play pop of the game. 4:32 to go in the first, no score. Adams a hold at 15:28 of this first period. Tom Meese will have the Bud Light scoreboard between periods, and his in-studio guest will be a commentator on ESPN during rounds 2 and 3 beginning next week, the general manager of the New York Rangers, Phil Esposito. So Espo and Tom between periods, as well as Tom checking out the Bud Light scoreboard. I'm sure that Tom is focusing his attention on this game, but it must seem very quiet back there for him since he doesn't have the 7 TVs to watch. Prop with a shot. That one blocked away by Pete Peters. Cleared around by Hatcher, but kept by Prop. Sinisalo turns, locks up with Langway. Puck shoveled along, and Peter Zezel is in. He and Gustafson collide. Puck taken by Hatcher. Hatcher angles. Prop can't keep. 20 seconds gone on the power play. 4:10 remaining first period. No score in the game. Glad you're with us tonight on ESPN. Along with Bill Clement, Mike Emmerich from the Capitol Center in Landover, Maryland. Crossman angles in to get a curve. Flexed away by Peters. Sinisalo points it back to Crossman. Deals it back off to Peter Zezel. Kerr is at the front. Drive went wide. Prop fires one. Blocked away by a falling Bent Gustafson. And the Flyers have to regroup. Just as Philadelphia had to pick up from killing off four straight power plays, perhaps Washington can take some consolation if they're able to kill this one off. Although this is just the first Philadelphia power play of the night. Howe turns it back along with 55 seconds to go on the power play. Eklund slides it over to Samuelson, who unwinds for the angle that is taken by Peters. Flip back to Howe. And he was ready to shoot before he controlled.
What a break. Peters didn't get nearly enough of that. He kind of fanned on the backhand, but it bounced anyway over Mark Howe's stick.
Eklund playing for Philadelphia with 30 seconds to go on the power play. Just over 3 minutes to play in a scoreless first period. Eklund shuffles in. Centers one off Ledyard. Loose puck. It's fed back to Howe. Wrist shot blocked off by Peters. Loose puck scooped up. There'll be a penalty coming up. And it'll be on the Capitals. It's Howe with a shot, knocked down by Bobby Gould, and Gould just throws it all the way back down the ice, but his team will go short, protesting his Ledyard. There will be a 5-on-3 for Philadelphia for 14 seconds.
Well, Ledyard's arguing the fact because... Oh, listen to this. Did you hear that?
A major.
Watching it, penalty, number 28, Brad Ledyard. A major for spearing and a game.
A major penalty means that the Flyers can score at will. 14. And whoever serves the major for Ledyard will not come out of the box. That major carries with it an automatic game misconduct.
I'm not sure that Ledyard didn't spear him when he was sitting in the seat of his pants right in front of Pete Peters. And that's what Ledyard, I think, was arguing originally, that he got knocked down.
This call will shorten the Washington bench by one for the rest of the night.
Tell you, talk about some key calls that so far haven't affected the game because there's no score, but here we have one. There's the shot by Mark Howe. There is Ledyard down in front. Watch. There's the spear right there, just on the right of your screen. He was sitting on the seat of his pants. He speared whoever the Flyer was standing right in front of him.
believe it might have been Craven. I think I saw 32. But a team that has two defensemen who are playing over injury right now in Langway and Stevens has lost one of the healthy ones for the night in Grant Ledyard. A 5-on-3 power play for 14 seconds. And this power play will extend into the second period unless there are further penalties, and those to Philadelphia. Craven for the faceoff with Gustafson. Howe gives it across. Trop waiting. Feeds one. One-time attempt by Cinesano wide. And it's fed back off the glass by Langway. In 4 seconds, Adams will be out of the box.
Well, that clear will get them out of the 5-on-3 situation.
Out comes Adams with the puck. Howe hammered from behind by Adams. The puck right over to Craven. At the side. Kerr score! Tim Kerr with a power play goal on the major penalty power play. It is 1-0 Philadelphia.
What a touch for a big man. I'm not even sure it was a shot, but it found its way right through Pete Peters. You know, Adams came out of the penalty box here, and you notice that he didn't concentrate on the puck. He just swung wildly at Mark Howe and hit him, and the puck ended up going over to Howe's partner, and there you saw Tim Kerr at the side of the net. Almost looked as if he was trying for a pass. Watch Adams simply hatchet Mark Howe over to Craven, into Tim Kerr, and here's Brian Plopp. Absolute pass. That was not a shot on goal. It bounced in, I think, off the blocker or off of Peter's stick. One way or the other, Tim Kerr gets his first playoff goal, and it's a key goal because the Capitals still have 4 minutes and 38 seconds left of this major penalty to kill off. 2:23 to go in this period, so they'll open up the second period with a man advantage as well.
Craven and Howe get the assist on Kerr's goal. Crossman banks it in. Pete Peters behind, lifts one that clicked off the glass and went out of play, so there'll be no penalty to Peters. Again, the ruling is if it goes clean over the glass, directed by the goaltender, it's an automatic minor. But if it catches the glass and then sails into the seats, no penalty.
For those of you who are statistics-minded, the first goal of each of the games in this series hasn't necessarily been the game winner, but the team that scored the first one has gone on to win each one. The Flyers draw first blood here. There's Mark LaForest standing up behind. He's backing up Ron Hextall tonight. But I'm sure at this stage of the game, he knows that at any time he could be thrown in there.
Come from behind wins have been rare in the NHL this Stanley Cup year. Only 10 of the 45 games have been come from behind. But in this series, half of the wins have been on the part of a team that once trailed. Mark Howe turns over to Crossman, then to Ilkka Cinesalo. Under 2 minutes to play, first period. In case you're just joining us, Philadelphia leading in the game by a count of 1-0. They're operating on a major penalty 5-on-4 power play. Kelly Miller looks ahead toward Gould, but will carry himself. Took some lumber from Kerr. Miller taken off by Crossman. One-time New York Ranger Kelly Miller loses, but it is Cinesalo now to Crossman, reconnecting with Cinesalo. Eklund hops over the boards and Kerr steps off for Philadelphia, having gotten his first goal of the playoff year, and it came on the power play. Eklund starting ahead, pivots away from Stevens, lays it for Craven behind. Prop yelled for the puck, but it's over to him too late. Craven out in front. They try to get it to Tockett, and he's able to control back to Prop. Then to Tockett. Tockett read the fake by Howe. Hatcher locked up by Craven. Play made to Sundstrom in the final minute of this first period. Again, Tom Meads and Phil Esposito will discuss this, another playoff contest between periods, and Tom will run a check of the Bud Light scoreboard. Big drive by Crossman. Clicked away. Peters able to scoop it up and hang on with 45 seconds to go in the period. The glove hand was one of the things that they felt Pete Peters was lax on when he first came to Washington. And Warren Strelo, the goaltending coach for the Capitals, has worked not only on Pete's agility, but also on quickness with the glove.
You can say what you want about him having deficiencies. Did you see that goals against average 2.78 this year, tops in the National Hockey League? So he plays for a team here that's defensive oriented. You got to be able to stop the puck most of the time. You just can't be a bad goalie and get in there and have those kind of numbers. I don't care who you're playing behind.
Peter Zezel and Hunter for the faceoff. It's lifted by Stevens but kept by Howe. punches it back along, but it's broken up and cleared back down by Scott Stevens. Stevens, normally a left sider, has moved across to the right in this shorthand situation. 30 seconds to go on the power play. Winner of this game goes into a best of seven series against those surprising New Jersey Devils. It is Peters flipping it back along. It scales out near Crossman. Markow returns to Crossman. 15 seconds to go in the period. Play made back to Howe. Punched away by Gustafson. Slugged back in by Tockett. Peters scoops over to Scott Stevens in the final nickel's worth of the period. Tipped back along by Gustafson. That'll do it.
And 1-1 Philadelphia.
20 minutes have passed. 1-0 Philadelphia.
You saw Ron Hextall skating off the ice. To me, he is back. I wouldn't have believed that a goalie could turn it off, turn it on with a switch. Ron Hextall had apparently lost his game. Tonight, he has found it.
Through 20 minutes on Tim Kerr's goal at 17:36. The score of the Philadelphia Flyers 1 and the Washington Capitals 0. 2 minutes and 14 seconds of power play time to Philadelphia at the start of this period. Crossman and Brian Propp will be the point men for the Flyers. Craven, Kerr, and Tockett up front. Pete Peters handles, guides it, but to Tockett. Checked on the play by Hatcher, and Bobby Gould is able to chip it off Propp, and in stride, it's taken by Miller. Gould is the trailer, but the play went offside at the line.
How close was that? Bobby Gould came all the way from his end, outlegged everybody, and broke loose. If that play is onside, he's in pretty well alone. Well, the first period was pretty well power play for both teams. It really was the story, and our voice-activated computer stats tell us that the total time for the Flyers on the power play was 4:45. Their attack zone time, not bad, respectable, only two shots, but the big one, they scored a goal. It was specialty teams time, and this is what plagued the Capitals in the first period. 0-for-4, they only spent 2 minutes of almost 7 minutes of power play time in the attack zone and weren't able to score. So far, that has been the entire difference in this hockey game, what the teams have done on their special teams.
Offside called once more. We should point out that that one power play was the one that was completed. This one is still ongoing, and because the Flyers have already scored on the major penalty power play, when this one is figured at the end of the period, it'll count as two. If the Flyers score again, this power play will count as three. It's an unusual sort of way that they do it, and I think someday eventually the league will come around to allotting power play statistics in terms of the time that you're on the power play, as we have done here at ESPN, rather than just counting the number of opportunities, because some of them are very short, and then others become quite elongated. Here we have Craven and Gould for the faceoff with a minute and 45 seconds to go on the major penalty power play. Kevin Hatcher on the turning stick of Gould, off the stick of Howe. Howe looks toward Kerr but will carry it himself. Smooth skating defenseman hands over to Big Shell Samuelson for the drop back in that is read by Peters. Just puts the scoop on it and gets the stoppage of play. Oh, a little something afterwards, and Tim Kerr comes back with a vengeance on Gould.
Did he ever?
It will cost Kerr, and him only, 19-10 to go second period. Flyers lead 1-0.
You know, sometimes frustration is an unforgiving emotional reaction. At least you don't want to react emotionally. I'm sure Mike Keenan would have preferred Tim Kerr exercise a little more discipline. Bobby Gould had given Kerr a shot. Kerr retaliated. That's what Koharski saw. So that evened the situation here. No more power play for the Philadelphia Flyers. But those are the kind of frustrations in a seventh game you have to squash. I mean, now is the time to forget about the frustration. Put it in a bottle. If you don't put it in a bottle, very often you could end up trying to outlet it on a golf course instead of in the next series.
A minute 10 from now, the Capitals, because of the Kerr penalty, will have a power play. Stevens with a good hard drive, answered by the pad of Hextall. Brian Propp lays it back ahead, and Howe was shouldered right down by Gustafson. Play made in by Poulin. Took a whack from Christian. leaned on and taken out of the play by Larry Murphy. Stevens can't control. It is Prop sweeping. Prop in front with a shot. Ricochet. And it's poked away by Peters to the corner. Samuelson a drive. Save. Rebound. Score. Ryan Prop. And the Flyers are ahead 2-0.
There goes the guffaw. Ryan Prop's post-goal celebration. Prop ended up over in the corner. It was Prop that passed it back to Samuelson, and out of the right of your screen, you could see that Prop was headed right back to an area that he is very familiar with, right in front of the net. Peters had trouble with the rebound. There's the original save. Stevens knocks it to the corner. Down goes Peters. Up he gets. Let's see if it was a screenshot coming from the point. There it is. Well, it wasn't really much of a screenshot, but Peters, when he made the pass save, directed it the exact worst place he could direct it, right back to where Brian Prop was coming. Prop snapped it home. The Flyers have a 2-0 lead. That was an even strength goal. That was a power play.
Both teams were a man short at the time. Samuelson gets the only assist. Now, in 39 seconds, the Caps will wind up with that approximately 25-second power play. Kevin Hatcher goes back to get it. Rolls it along, but Craven is there. Dumps it, and Langway must take over. Pivoting from Sinisalo. Nearly outmanned, but gets it along to Mike Gartner. Gartner with only one goal in this series thus far. Moves in on Crossman. Good shot, but right into the letters of Hextall, who hangs on, and then jabbing it away was Hatcher. But Hextall, I think, showing some restraint there, because normally he might come charging right out.
He did take a swat. He didn't use all that much restraint, but you're right. He could have charged after him. It's funny, when things are going bad, and Ron Hextall knows about the bad and the good, when things are going bad, pucks find a way to get through you. It doesn't matter where the shot is coming from. It seems to find a hole some way to get through you. And when you're hot, pucks hit you. The same ones that find a way to get through you when you're hot hit you. So far tonight, they have all hit Ron Hextall.
The shots in the first period were 6 for Philadelphia and 4 for Washington. Puck squibs right on Hextall, and he lays it back up to Dave Poulin. Poulin moving out with Craven. Puck laid back across to Samuelson. And Samuelson works it deep. Laid it right in front, and Hatcher was there. The power play has now begun to Washington. Scott Stevens wheeling it back up ice. His team trailing. In this seventh game of the first round of the Stanley Cup playoffs, the score 2-0, Samuelson makes them chase again. 15 seconds to go on the man advantage. I'm sure one of the Flyers' objectives in getting a lead was to take the fans out of it, because they were resounding with their ovation to the Capitals at the start of the game. It has gotten quiet. Hatcher throws. Mark Howe knocks it down. Howe looks ahead toward Poulin, but plays to Tim Kerr. Kerr's pass is over to Howe. Wrist shot, he scores! Woo! Mark Howe with a scorching wrist shot. And it is a 3-0 Philadelphia lead.
And when he is up on the play, which is very, very often, Mark Howe has the most dangerous wrist shot in the National Hockey League. And what a blast with the wrists right up over Pete Peters' shoulder. I don't care if the Flyers thought Pete Peters didn't have much of a club hand one way or the other. He wasn't even going to get close to this one. Look at that shot. Right up in tight. Peters didn't even have a chance to move. Nobody has picked up Howe. It was Howe to Tim Kerr, who had just come out of the penalty box. And Kerr all the way back across ice to Mark Howe. There's the pass over to Kerr. Howe digs in and keeps going. Nobody picks him up. There he is. Mike Gardner had a chance at him, but too late. Bingo. 3-0 Flyers.
And Brad Marsh just denied a good opportunity, as Bobby Gould might have been able to get in. Rod Langway spins it along for the Capitals. Puck given up to Sutter. Shovels over for Dave Brown, but instead it's Adams. Doug Crossman takes over for the Flyers. Hands over to Sutter. Puck dribbled in, and they rule an onside play, apparently. Nope, now it's called. Looked as though Smith was in well early, and there'll be a face-off coming back to center ice. 16:31 to go in the second. Philadelphia leading 3-0.
Our screen replay sponsors the second period.
Howe with the third Flyer goal, his third of the playoffs, the lone assist to Tim Kerr, and Philadelphia strikes twice in a minute and 24 seconds. Gustafson on the draw with Zezel. And it is Pavanka, one of the top scorers for the Capitals in this series, trying to lay it across for Christian. Punched away by Marsh and swept back to Galli. Galli's pass broken up by Sinisalo. His shot snared by Peters. And at this stage, you'd have to think that's a big save for Pete Peters, even though there certainly are very few goaltenders in this light year of hockey who could ever have gotten Mark Howe's shot.
You're right. The Flyers are hungry now in the neutral zone. That's how they broke up this play. Sinisalo moved in. Peters had to make a good save. The Capitals are sagging. There's no question about it. They don't have the sharpness in the neutral. The Flyers are all over them. It's another key time of this hockey game. Three, that's close to being out of reach. You know that the Caps need one. They need one bad now.
Native of Edmonton, Alberta, whose training included the Milwaukee Admirals, the Maine Mariners, and then Philadelphia, Boston, and Washington in the NHL, watches this face-off that we're watching here, along with Bill Clement, Mike Emmerich from Capital Center, 3-0 Flyers, Game 7, 16:07 to go in the second, and Pete Peters was swung around just now by Zezel as the puck dropped in for Gartner's shot, and that trickled wide. Ilkka Sinisalo starts it back out. Pass ahead, clicks to Marsh. Marsh on the wing, pivoting is Craven. Locked up by Hatcher. Trying to jab it along is Mike Gartner. Kicking at it is Zezel. Shouldered by Hatcher. Zezel continues to try to work it with his skates. One-time professional soccer player is Zezel. Very crafty with the puck in his skates, but this one squibs over to Scott Stevens. Kelly Miller bumped off by Sinisalo, but not until he got the pass through to Ridley. Ridley tries once and loses. Sinisalo spins it, but beyond the reach of Zezel and down for an icing touch-up. If Hatcher gets there first, he does. With 15 minutes and 20 seconds to go in this middle period, Kerr, Propp, and Howe have goals for Philadelphia. The Flyers are ahead 3-0. Big Kevin Hatcher, youthful defenseman who really giving Washington some depth on defense when you stop to think of Langway and Scott Stevens still with years ahead of them. Langway with the fewer, of course, but still two very strong defensemen. And then the production that Hatcher has had, not only with the defense, but offensively, too. He's a threat to stick handle and carry, and such a big man.
He'll have to do it now, won't he? He had 14 goals during the regular season, four here in the playoffs for Washington. Somebody's going to have to get it going for the guys in white. The Flyers have slowly but surely played a Flyers kind of game. They came out very physical. Pecked away, strong penalty killing. That's another trademark of the Flyers. And look what we have here, a 3-0 Philadelphia lead. 15 minutes to go in the second period.
Puck forced away and then taken by Samuelson. Korobo flips one that is guided away by Dave Poulin. On now to Tockett. Tockett drills in. Peters sees it skip behind him. In to get it is Poulin, rammed to the boards and glass by Dale Hunter. Hunter dumps it along, but it's kept by Propp. Flipped behind, Poulin to get it. Tockett runs interference on Langway. Puck given up to Hunter. Scales one off the glass that popped near Samuelson, and Poulin with a good one-timer and an equally good stick reaction by Pete Peters. Howe takes a look. Strides away from Sundstrom. Watched by Hunter. Spun one in front that was nearly directed on by the skate of Tockett. Langway back. Hands over to Murphy, who banks it back in. Washington's forechecking has not been powerful in this game. Flyers are able to move it ahead at will as Poulin connects with Brad Marsh. 14:20 to go in the second. Philadelphia leading in the game 3-0. Scott Stevens, head man, but under the stick of Korobo. Doug Crossman connects on to Pelle Ekblom. Lays it up the wing for Kerr. Wrist shot is blocked away by Peters. It's chopped over to Korobo. Lays it ahead now for Christian to carry. Moving on Crossman. Christian a backhander tipped away by Crossman. Mellenby over. Hit by Scott Stevens. Puck picked up though by Ekblom and off the glove of Gustafson. The Caps must regroup. Stevens with a pass that escapes deep. Flyers want icing. They get it. With 13:43 to go in the second period. Philadelphia 3 and the Capitals nothing. The network of the Stanley Cup playoffs is ESPN. Sam Rosen and Phil Esposito will be joining our ESPN crew for telecast next week in the Prince of Wales Conference. New Jersey against the winner of this game in one series. The other will match Montreal and Boston. Bill Clement and I will head to the Campbell Conference, where the matchups will be Calgary, Edmonton, St. Louis, and Detroit. The man in charge, Don Koharski, worked the key games of the Canada Cup. It's been a long year for him, too. Brown hurried one on goal. Peters sweeps it along to Gould. And Gould tosses, but to Doug Crossman of Philadelphia. 13 and a half minutes to play, second period. Dave Brown hooks it back in. To get it is Hatcher. Banks it off for Adams. Checked by Brown, but he gets it through to Hunter. Up the wing is Gould as Hunter carries and looks for him. The pass spun back for a drive by Gelly. He scores!
The feed is from Dale Hunter to a man up on the play from his defense point, Gary Galley. It doesn't take him long to get rid of the shot. And you could see a crowd going in front of Ron Hextall if you were watching the lower part of your screen. Hextall shot out of his net, complaining to Don Koharski. Koharski explained that he was going to call an interference penalty against one of the Flyers anyway. Bobby Gould was number 23 of the Washington Capitals, who crossed in front of Hextall and got a piece of him. Koharski waved it off. What a blast right by Ron Hextall. Is that the one the Capitals need? At least they're in the game now. 3-1 Philadelphia.
And the crowd is in it too, as a quick play at the front denied by Peters on the pass toward Tockett. Hunter and Adams get the assist on Galley's first of the playoffs at 6:42 of the second period. On comes Tockett, has Poulin with him. Big drive eaten up by the stick of Peters. And the crowd now starts to chant Pete, Pete. It is Christian, turning, able to shuffle it ahead to Murphy. Works it on to Pavanka. Man on the wing is Christian. Save made by Hextall. Christian continues to work. Jams it on to Gustafson. Tries to stop her, but falls. Tockett battles with Christian. Puck kept along by Stevens. Gustafson wrapped up by Samuelson, and Tockett decides to just toss it out. Murphy gets it. Hands over to Stevens. Pass tipped, but taken by Pavanka. Given up to Shel Samuelson. Right back is Pavanka. Feathers to Christian. Backhander save made by Hextall. And Tockett drills it back down the ice. Oh, the Caps are knocking on the door. Action stopped on the icing with 12:04 to go in the second. Can you feel the breeze, Bill?
You can feel some of the cap pressure. Christian tries to get the puck up and does just at the last second. Ron Hextall did not commit first. That's another sign that he's back on top of his game. And I think you want to look at this game so far. Here's Christian again going to his backhand. Hextall follows him, makes the save. Christian was trying to slide it between his legs. So far in this hockey game, this is the key sequence. Those two saves by Ron Hextall when the Capitals were surging. Coming back from a 3-0 deficit, they get one, they really press, the Flyers slam the door shut on him. This is key so far.
Rudy battles his way to the front, they score! Kelly Miller! And it is 3-2!
The Caps were not out of adrenaline from that first goal. Peter Zezo kicks it to one of his own teammates, and that's Doug Crossman. But you can see the confusion. Kelly Miller just heads for the goal. Somehow Ron Hextall is not able to tie it up. Let's look at it again. There's the kick by Zezo. Zezo goes down. Miller goes all the... Well, I'll tell you what. When you look at that closely, you have to think that Ron Hextall might have been playing the pass. It looked as if he was leading instead of playing the puck, playing the pass. And Kelly Miller had a few inches to slip it home, and he did. Look out, here come the Caps.
Ridley gets the lone assist at 8:02. On now comes Craven. Hands to Mark Howell. A wrist shot trapped and held by Peters. So calm. He has been so calm all week.
I wonder if Ron Hextall might have lost his balance on that last goal. Here's the last save by Peters. Mark Howell looked as if Howell was trying to go high to the glove side again, but you can see Peters, the backs of his skates are just on his crease, so he has the angle pretty well cut down. There's the action for Hextall and Peters tonight. Pretty similar at both ends.
Two nights ago, they were waving sponge fingers in New Jersey. Tonight, it is the white pom-poms, all being directed at the Conn Smythe Trophy winner of last year, who is about 150 feet away from this faceoff at the other end, Ron Hextall. Tim Curt of Battle wins the faceoff. A chop shot by Howe is blocked down. Galley steps away, wedges one that will be collared by Samuelson. Skating it down is Eklund. Taps, but to Galley. Galley back for the Capitals, has a man breaking Greg Adams. A shot is saved by Hextall. He didn't see the rebound. And it's cleared away. Eklund can't clear. Capped in by Gould, but given up to Howe. Man, oh man, and a pass tip all the way over the end glass. A neutralized faceoff will resolve. Heart-stopping action here at the Cap Center. 11:01 to go in the second. Flyers 3 and the Capitals 2. Four days ago, they thought they'd be watching movies on television tonight. But they're here, shaking pom-poms, all in the direction of the ice, which has seen their team come from a 3-0 deficit with two goals in the span of a minute and 20 seconds to tighten this one up again. Along with Bill Clement and Tom Eves back at our studios, Mike Emmerich on ESPN. Miller checked by Brad Marsh. In barrels Ridley to lay into Sutter. Puck kicked along and Stevens pinches. Sutter can step back out. They've got a 2-on-2. Play made to Derek Smith. Sutter moves to the net. The wrist shot is a high one that is trapped and held by Pete Peters.
He had to pick it up visually out of a crowd, rather. Ron Sutter just barrels for the net. There is Smith going wide. There's 14 on the left. Sutter just keeps on going. He puts his head down. Now he tries to curve into Peters. He's the guy that created the problem for Pete Peters. Peters not only looked as if he was screened, but Sutter was right there for the rebound. Boy, when push comes to shove, you get into a tight situation. 3-2 hockey game. It's not the fancy plays that you end up counting on. It's the guys like Sutter, the guys like Bobby Gould wearing number 23 for the Capitals, and Kelly Miller put their heads down, drive for rebounds. You have to create your breaks in situations like this.
Ice being repaired. You see the chorus as they chant Hextall, they wave. Warren Strelo, the man who has trained Pete Peters and given him some solid coaching here in Washington, said, playoff hockey is like going to the butcher shop and you are the meat and you're stuck into the grinder and cranked out. If you win, they wad you back up again so you're whole and put you back in another time. Well, the Caps have been through and wadded back up twice in the last four nights. They hope they can be tapped back into a solid ball for another round after this one. Play made ahead to Gustafson. Gustafson for Pavanka, but it's behind him. Fed back out by Tockett. Poulin can't force it by Langway, but here's Tockett moving in. Denied by Hatcher. Poulin follows up. One. A shot is blocked away. Rebound centered, but taken by Gustafson, who starts back up with Christian. Leaves it for Christian. Watched by Howe. Christian, a shot and a rising one, and then Hextall is rammed by one of the Capitals, and a scuffle develops as Hextall remains flat on his back.
Man, was he steamrolled by a combination of a few people, including number 4 of the Capitals, Kevin Hatcher, who was moving to the net. But there was a whole crowd of people, including a couple of Flyers that were going back as well. too big a crowd to really figure out what was happening. A replay might be able to dissect it, but there you see Ron Hextall lying. He had the hip, at least his back, if not the back of his head, on the net. Let's take a look at it. Samuelson and Howe coming back. Right down the middle comes Kevin Hatcher. There's the shot up high. Oh, man, I'll tell you what. Hatcher could have avoided that. Rick Tocchet might have given him a jostle, but this is a seventh game maneuver if I've ever seen one. Watch Hextall trying to get control. Hatcher leans right into him. Boom!
For that, he got a minor for interference.
Ron Hextall has complained all season long that people are taking him out of the crease. Nobody has been sympathetic to Ron Hextall's plight because he dishes so much out. I mean to tell you something, sports fans, he really got his clock cleaned by an intentional shoulder by Hatcher right there. That was Hatcher driving for the net. Those are the kind of things that you got to count on. Hey, it's a 3-2 hockey game.
Yep.
This is game seven. Fasten your seatbelts. Hexy knows about it. Hatcher knows about it. They all know the score.
Yeah, everybody knows the deal.
You bet.
Hatcher got the minor. It was interference at 10:05. Philadelphia to get power play number four. So the power play on the night, Philadelphia going on its fourth. The Capitals have had five. One power play collected, and that by Philadelphia's Tim Kerr, who is out there right now on right wing. Eklund the left. Craven the centerman. The point men will be Howe and Samuelson, who have logged their usual abundance of time tonight. Stevens speaking of a lot of time, and Langway back on defense. Miller and Gould up front, and Gould caused that one to be deflected back over to Howe. Spins it back along for Eklund. It rolls the rail, guided by Langway to Stevens, who's able to tap to Gould, and he banks it back out. Mark Howe pursued by Miller. 35 seconds gone on the power play. 9:15 to go in the second. 3-2, Philadelphia leading. Winner plays the exciting New Jersey Devils in the second round, the round that will commence on Monday. And the winner of this game will host game one. We'll have it for you on ESPN. Huffman starts back. 1:05 to go power play. By our recollection, his first shift of the game. This one turned back around by Gould and cleared back down by Sundstrom. Shift change on now for Washington. They have Murphy working with Stevens back on defense. Gustafson and Sundstrom are up front. Huffman tries the hard around once more. This time it swirls near Tocchet. Nearly had it picked away by Murphy. Puck pops along and is guided but not out by the Caps. Turning with it is Sinisalo. Half a minute to go on the power play. Sinisalo in the corner. Couldn't get it by Scott Stevens, who hand passes it ahead. It's tipped back along and is played by Huffman. Huffman back. Pass, diving play made by Gustafson. What an atmosphere. Crowd responding to every solid Capitals play. In with this one comes Sinisalo. Couldn't get by Stevens, and it's poked back out. 5 seconds to go on the power play. Zezel moves it back over to Markow. Pass tip comes over to Sinisalo. Penalty time is up. The Caps have killed it off, and here comes Kevin Hatcher. Hatcher with a forehander stopped for the pad of Hextall and scooped up by Howe, but given up to Ridley. Hextall sets it up for Shel Samuelson. Pass went under Sinisalo and off Langway, so there'll be no icing here. Pete Peters watches as Galley comes by. Tripped up by Sutter. Delayed penalty call is on. And because a flyer did touch it, we get the stoppage of play. Power play coming up. They trail by one.
Here's what the Flyers did on that last power play. You can tell that Washington is adrenaline-filled right now. Only 20 seconds of attack zone time. No shots. And will the pendulum swing back now? Ron Sutter is off for tripping right here. He just gets his stick under Gary Galley's left skate. Down goes Galley. Off goes Sutter. And the momentum is visibly shifted time and time again. One more look at it. It's actually the right skate. He just got his blade right under it. Boy, there have been shifts in this hockey game. The game starts. The Capitals have all kinds of opportunities on the power play early. They get nothing. The Flyers hold their ground, open up a 3-0 lead, are walking away with it. The Capitals get a goal. The momentum starts coming back the other way, and then Kelly Miller scores. Here we are with a chance for the Caps to draw even.
And Mike Gartner is the first to take. Hextall behind. It clipped through him and is taken by Ridley. Gartner shakes to the front of the net while all this is going on, but the Caps can't get it to him yet. Mark Howe there. Spun it along, but it hit Ridley. The battle continues along the boards. Tipped by Galley, followed up by Samuelson. He clears. Hatcher and Galley are the point men. We mentioned Gartner and Ridley. And the other Cap is Dale Hunter. Howe and Samuelson in back. A change up front. It's Sinisalo and Craven to defend. Hatcher tried to play it in. It kicked back, and Craven wants to start ahead. But Gary Galley nicely took it away and headmans on now to Gartner. Gartner loses to Mark Howe.
How many times has he lost to Mark Howe? That is the matchup Keenan wants. He wants Mark Howe out there when Gartner is out there. And Howe has been outstanding against Gartner.
Galley to Hunter, swept away by Samuelson. Galley battles again, and Hunter wedges. They set it up for Hatcher. Sixth save made by Hextall. Galley right back to Gartner. Fires. Save Hextall. Rebound poked away by Samuelson from Hunter. Another shot by Hatcher. Hextall got a stick on that one. And Mark Howe is able to lob it back out.
No one there for the rebounds. You know who did an outstanding job? Mark Howe in keeping Ridley away from Hextall. Ridley was trying to get position on him, but Mark Howe knows how to position himself. Every time the shot came, Howe said, okay, Hextall, you make the save. I'll take care that nobody gets to you from at least my side for the rebound.
We'll watch to see if it happens again. 20 seconds to go on the Caps power play. It takes one right now for him to tie. Pavanka wrestled to the boards and glass by Samuelson. Loose puck comes across and is tapped away. Christian shaking loose. 5 seconds to go on the power play. Can't get it through. It's poked along by Propp. Gathered in by Larry Murphy. And out of the box comes Sutter. Teams are back at full strength. Here is Pavanka, sized up by Marsh, can't get it through. Ron Sutter pivots with it, lost it though, and Christian with a drive that is popped high into the air and out of play.
They want to welcome and thank our good friends.
Well, they had their chances, didn't they? And what an outstanding play by Brad Marsh right at the end. There were two Caps zeroing in. Christian tried to shoot. That was Pavanka getting ridden out by Big Shell Samuelson.
All right.
And a chance that went right off the tip of Gustafson's stick.
Boy, as many shifts as there have been in strength in this game tonight, we are nowhere near the most dramatic part of this game. You would think 3-2, Philadelphia ahead, 5-12 to go in the second. In the second.
Three shots by the Capitals, pretty good ones.
Bob Hodges getting them lined up. He's the linesman who drops it. It's tapped by Miller, wrapped up by Doug Crossman. Miller still trying to get away, able to take it. Miller has Stevens who wants it in front. The shot turned in on Hextall, and he hangs on. 5:01 to go. Period of play. It is still the Flyers 3 and the Capitals 2. A drive by Stevens has just been deflected off the post. Sundstrom at center ice has it taken away by Brown. Cleared back along by Murphy, but into the shins of Gould. Sutter tries to get to the corner. Leaned on by Gould, and the Caps able to outman. Derek Smith stepped into Murphy, but not until he turned it back out. Brad Marsh hammers one back in that cracks off the glass. Scott Stevens pivoting. Shovels along, wanting Miller, but instead has Brown for a centering pass, and Derek Smith couldn't turn it in. Marsh chops one. High off of Murphy. Loose puck backhanded wide by Sutter. Samuelson taps it back along. Sutter tries to turn it loose, but it is Stevens lifting into the glove of Sundstrom, who sends it back to the Flyers' end. And the Capitals are finally able to make a shift change. 4 minutes to go in the second. Philadelphia ahead in the game 3-2. Puck chopped out of play and a faceoff result. Back in the Capitals' end. We'll be right back.
Here's Ron Hextall at his end right off the post. We were just coming back from a break when that one dinged off the post. That's as close as the Capitals have come in the last couple of minutes, but it has turned into a seesaw battle. Got to look to the foot soldiers. right now. Kelly Miller has been outstanding in this game. Ron Sutter, Derek Smith have both had their chances.
Remember a year ago tonight, Bill, we talked about the same sort of people that we thought would explode in the overtime, maybe get that one chance. Greg Smith hit the post against the Islanders in that multiple overtime game. Lou Franceschetti nearly slid one in. But what an exhibition, and it's still sharp in our memories. Kelly Rudy and then Mason at that time was the Washington Capitals goalie, and it was 1 year ago tonight. Here, we're in the second period. Flyers are ahead by a count of 3-2. 4:01 left in the second. Crossman clears. And over the end line it goes, but they will wave icing off. So Kevin Hatcher will see play continue as he works it back for Steve Leach, but that skidded by. I believe this is Leach's first shift of the game as the play made across from Eklund to Crossman, and Crossman hammers one on goal from 80 feet. Rod Langway is there. The shots were 6-4 Philadelphia in the first period. Right now, the Caps have 13 in this period, and the Flyers have 14. And there was a difficult 14th shot by Washington on Hextall.
It wasn't really a difficult save for Hextall, but he had trouble picking it up. As soon as it hit him, he lost it.
Kevin Hatcher wheels on defense, has Adams nearby and shovels to him. Adams moving on Crossman. Centers one across the goal mouth. Scott Stevens away from the diving attempt by Eklund. Good shot save. Rebound out in front. They scramble for it, and able to come up with it is Eklund. On the wing to Mellenby. A 3-on-2, but a very deliberate one as the Flyers want to get a change. Scott Stevens headmans back to Hunter. Hunter drills it in. Hextall in back, couldn't stop. It trickles toward Marsh, but is played by Craven. Given up to Hunter. Pivots away from one. Passes for Miller, but it's booted away by Marsh and brought back up by Zezel. Up the wing, breakaway for Craven. Tripped up, and the puck went in on goal. Play continues, no penalty call. Back up with it, Ridley. Right wing with it is Gartner. Gartner pivots the net, ridden along by Marsh. Stoppage of play as the net has been dislodged.
Hextall is down on one knee, but everybody now is buzzing over the non-call at the other end on that Murray Craven breakaway. I'd have to see it again, but you know, yeah. From here it looked like it wasn't a bad call. I think that Stevens got Craven's stick right there. Watch now. All he did was go down Craven's stick, and Craven tried to take a shot. Stevens was able to jam the blade of his stick. Watch right here now. He slides down. That's when Craven goes down. Now, if the call was going to be made, it had to be made, or it was Galley, not Stevens, it had to be made earlier than that, because when Craven went down, it was simply because he lined himself up to shoot, and Galley slid all the way down the shaft of his stick and simply locked stick blades with him. I don't think he laid a stick in any part of his body.
It looked bad,
but Koharski was on that side of the ice.
And our hat's off to him, because we had to see it on a replay to tell for sure. Good work with the cameras too, man.
He might have wanted to call one on the first part. You know, when he was being hooked, I think that Craven was being hooked on the first part of that breakaway, but I think Koharski wanted to wait and see how it turned out. Didn't call anything.
One to Murphy. Slams one off the leg of Kropp. Forced back to the glass by Hextall. Samuelson locks up there with Gustafson. Stoppage of play. Puck frozen with 2:15 to go in the second. Philadelphia with the first three goals. Kerr late in the first on a power play. Prop and Howe a minute and 24 seconds apart early in the second. And it seemed to be all Philadelphia. That's the way things had shifted. But Gary Galley at 6:42. And a minute and 20 seconds later, Kelly Miller. After Mike Ridley did a lot of work in tying up Zezel so that he couldn't get the loose puck that was out near the front of the goal, Miller was able to control and put one underneath Ron Hextall to bring this team back to within one. He's been solid throughout in this contest. Pete Peters. Hextall has shown some signs in moments of not being too sharp. Gustafson ready for the faceoff. Murphy and Hatcher in back, and it's to Murphy. Just swings one toward the goal that's tipped away by Hextall. Brian Prop lifts. Hatcher keeps. Big drive. Score!
Will be A long intermission for Brian Propp. He tries to flip it over everybody's head from deep in the corner, and he doesn't get it by big number four's head, Kevin Hatcher, who booms one right along the ice on the short side, past Ron Hextall, and ties this hockey game. Hatcher simply stood his ground. There is Hatcher knocking down the flip shot from Brian Propp that came all the way from the corner. Boom, right by Ron Hextall. And what a hockey game we have. His fifth goal of the playoffs.
An unassisted goal for Hatcher with 2:06 to go in the period. The Caps have come from down in the series 3-1. And in this deciding game, down in the game, 3-0. And we're right back where we started, even. Gustafson with 1:40 to go in the second period. Hooked at by Propp, swatted by Propp. Gustafson trying to control in traffic. Yanks one on that is tipped by Pavanka toward Christian. The battle continues as Howe able to free it, but it's taken by Gustafson. Turnarounder came toward Christian. Dave Christian tried to swing one through, but that denied by Howe. Pavanka had that one go off. Kulin shot by Christian to save. Another shot, and that one topped wide after hitting the post. Incredible. Tockett's pass is chased down by Hatcher. Chip James Philadelphia with 1:05 to go in the second period of play. Hatcher to Gartner, who pumps it back in, but off the linesman skates, and the Flyers take this opportunity to shoot it back down. They make a change as well. Marsh and Crossman are the defense, as the defense for Washington handles, and Murphy was hit hard by Derek Smith, but back up come his teammates. It's fed over to Scott Stevens. One-timer is answered by the stick of Hextall. Crossman glasses. Murphy kicked it back along, but he was outside the line. So offside halts the clock with 33 seconds left in the second period. And the fans here start to rise.
What a chance Dave Christian had right here. You know, Hextall looked as if he was going down on that shot for some reason, but there it was after the fact, after the save, Christian getting his rebound, and Hextall making possibly his best save on the recovery of the night. Watch Hextall move to his left right here. Boy, he had to be quick. Had he not been able to recover quickly enough from that first save, he wouldn't have had any traction with his skates. But Hextall was able to get back up and up to push off that right skate, move over to the left, and stifle Dave Christian.
Emerging from the faceoff is Eklund. Flips it, but into the glove of Rod Langway. Off Sundstrom, and along to be shot back in by Brad Marsh. Icing is waved off. Langway plays it along to Stevens. Dumps it off for Adams. In the final dozen seconds of a thrilling second period of play, Gould denied by Samuelson. Sundstrom hammers it back along, but it ricocheted and went out of play. With just 3 seconds to go in the period, there'll be a neutralized faceoff.
Well, we knew we didn't have any other games to take you to tonight in the event that this one ended up being a rout, so we asked the boys to keep it interesting, and if they ever obliged, thanks, Brian Murray. Thanks, Mike Keenan. They got to be, boy, turning gray by the second. You know, this, after playing 3 consecutive games where they had a sizable lead, Washington had to come from behind tonight. They were leading 4-1 in a hockey game that they lost in game 4. And then since then, they've taken it away from the Flyers. Well, they really had to come from behind here. The stage is completely set for an absolutely fantastic third period of a 7th game. We're tied at 3 after 40 minutes.
You think back. Some of these guys have been playing since July. They've been training since June. They've been involved in Canada Cup. 80 games of a regular season. 7th game of just the first round. It'll be the last for one, the beginning for another.
Cap Center is ready. The players are certainly ready. We hope you around the nation are ready. Period 3, Game 7, Patrick Division Semifinals. This is it. Unless we go to overtime, the Flyers and the Caps. Let's see who will come out on top, or if we'll need to play late into the night once again this year. Let's rejoin Mike Emmerich and Bill Clement.
Thank you, Tom. The shots in the second period, 19-15 Philadelphia, so the game heated up a lot, and we see it reflected in these.
Well, go down to the tough saves. 11 for Hextall, 10 for Peters. Only five shots total came from the blue line, from the point. See, two and three. One of those went by Ron Hextall. It was a blast by Kevin Hatcher, but they've had to make tough saves. Hextall had to be called upon to make more tough saves that period than Peters did, but a complete change of the game in that period, wide open compared to the tight checking that these two teams usually like to play.
Hatcher drops it in, Mark Howe to play. Christian the forechecker, it's a pass to Samuelson. Up the wing to Prop for a bullet drive. Stick save Peters and it popped away from him, but Langway is there. Puck shoveled by Samuelson, taken by Langway. Slides it quickly over to Hatcher, connects with Gustafson. Christian and Pavanka are the wingers for Gustafson, but no matter, Shel Samuelson breaks this one down. Directed by the skate of Poulin, but taken by the stick of Hatcher. Just underway, third period. Game seven, best of seven. Game tied, as the series is, at three. It is Poulin feeding it across to Samuelson for a big drive high off Peters, and the rebound taken by Langway. Pulls away from the forechecking of Toppin. Booming hit registered by Peters Ezell on Hatcher, but ahead with it comes Christian. Christian with a shot, and it went wide. Oh, he got everything on that wrist shot. Here is Ezell back to Craven. Tries to lead for Sinisalo, but he was in early, and offside is called. Ilka Sinisalo comes into this game with a four-game goal-scoring streak, and he has scored points in each of the games. He's been hot. Prop at a minute 35, then Howe at 2:59. Then came the Capitals. Galley 6:42, Miller at 8:02, Kevin Hatcher with 2:06 to go in the period, an unassisted blast. And we're even at three, as Ridley draws with Zezell. Puck kicks back to Brad Marsh, away from the hook attempt of Gartner, and it rolls around past Peters. Miller locks up with Sinisalo. Ridley slides it over to Gartner. Big drive is slowed by Brad Marsh. Out to get it as Hextall nearly went too far. Ridley booms up with Craven. Marsh trying to work it loose, able to get away from the paw of Gartner. And Marsh banks it off to Sinisalo. They've got a two-on-one. Play ahead to Zezell. Controls. Shot is blocked off by Peters. Stevens can't get out with it. Help comes from Larry Murphy. Pivoting is Sinisalo for the toss back. Again, the Flyers make a change on the fly. Ron Sutter comes out to work with Derek Smith. Also out for Philadelphia, Scott Mellenby. Ahead with this comes Gartner, eyed up by Howe. Wrist shot slowed by Howe. Sticked away by Hextall. Spun back around by Samuelson. Kept by Galley for a shot to hit a stick. Sutter shoulders Ridley and takes it, gives it up. Ridley a backhander, and it was tipped high. Man, oh man. And we're early in the third in these chances. Drive by Derek Smith. Blocked away by Peters. There'll be a penalty coming up. 17:34 to go in the third period. Game tied at three.
The first penalty of the third period is to Mike Gartner for a hook in the neutral zone. There it is on Ron Sutter. That's actually a left-hand shot, you know, that's hooking Sutter down. Here was Zezel's chance. Does this go off the handle of Pete Peters' stick, or does it go right between his arm and his body? It just squeezed through. Zezell was going high to the long side. Here's the action at the other end around Ron Hextall. Just up over the net.
Power play on for Philadelphia. Puck spun back down, and so it'll be Howe going back to get it. Hunter exchanges shoves with Eklund as Hunter leaves the ice. Penalty killers up front are Gould and Miller. In back, Hatcher and Langway. Puck dropped and Gould is back. Checked off by Eklund, and the puck golfed out of play. The faceoff will remain back in the Washington Capitals zone.
Well, you know, when you shoot the puck, it has to go in sooner or later. Kevin Hatcher's goal in the second period was his sixth shot on net in this hockey game. Power plays have been the situation. Here's what the Flyers have done. One for three. Only 2:24 in the attack zone. Only two shots. One of them a quality shot. They were able to capitalize on one. That was early in this hockey game, and it was really a pass that Tim Kerr tried to put through to Brian Klopp that found its way in behind Pete Peters.
Craven and Hunter for the faceoff, controlled by Hatcher, and it's kicked by Howe. A minute and a half to go on the power play. 17:05 left in the third. As the puck dished off to Shel Samuelson. Samuelson brings it on back. Rips it in. Peters crunches the boards to stop it. Sends it right back, and Samuelson, locked up by Sundstrom, gets help from Hatcher to send it back down. Caps have Gustafson working up front now, along with Sundstrom, and in back, it is Hatcher with Stevens, and Stevens knocked that Markow drive down. Sundstrom just goes for a skate and then lobs. 16 and a half to go, third period. 3-3 the score. The Capitals and the Flyers trying to decide who will play New Jersey in the Patrick Division Finals. Murphy, Banks, it sails out of play. And again, the faceoff will be close to Pete Peters. Mike Keenan has just directed Ilkka Sinisalo to hop back out. As you see, Pete Peters, the three strongest and most consistent players in this series have all been Scandinavians. Sinisalo, and on the other end of things, Gustafson and Pavanka.
Well, Michael Pavanka's had an outstanding series.
You see Ron Hextall way at the other end. Hunter having words with Kelly Miller, and now we'll move in. Hoffman has moved in on the left point of the power play. You see them line four straight up across, and the puck comes back to Propp. Propp shovels it over to Hoffman. Wrists one in front, and that's sailed off the glass. Zezel had it poked away by Hunter. Puck kept by Propp. Gives to Zezel. Deals it back off to Sinisalo. Still looking. Turns it to Zezel. Sinisalo. Hurried return. Comes back to Propp. Zezel once more. 18 seconds left power play. It's a give and go. Thrown to the front. Blocked off by Stevens. Cleared by Hatcher. Not out. It skips by Propp. And so the Flyers have to regroup. 10 seconds left on the man advantage as Tockett took a hit from Hatcher after he released that one that was cut off by Stevens. 2 seconds, one. Out of the box, Gartner. The Capitals have killed another one off. Hatcher for Gartner, but it was sent right back to Sinisalo, who starts in. Gartner heads back on Brad Marsh. Escapes the hook checking of Sinisalo. Squirrels a little pass on over to Christian, and Christian sailed one that Hextall didn't see. It appeared to glance off him. Then Murphy flipped one that Hextall has in tow this time to Shel Samuelson. Both goaltenders have had some close calls in this one. 38 seconds of attack zone time, no shot. 14:59 to go in the third. Game tied. We'd mentioned the presence of the European players. Sinisalo, Finnish native. Gustafsson from Sweden. Pavanka, Czechoslovakian. And the three key players. And often it was said that a lot of times you don't see the Europeans fighting so hard at playoff time, but that's sure different in this series. Delayed penalty call is coming up. And finally, the Flyers touch. And that will give the Capitals a man advantage in a game that is tied. With 14:47 to go in the... They're revved up now, aren't they? Samuelson tripping at 5:15. Kevin Hatcher slides it over for a shot by Galley. Another shot, they score! The nemesis of Philadelphia, Dale Hunter. Tie is broken as you see the goalie coach Warren Strahlo.
The right place at the right time. Gary Galley dumps it through to Dale Hunter right on the tape. I thought Galley was trying to take a shot on net, but it ended up right on Dale Hunter's backhand, right there. Ron Hextall is already down. He thought that the shot from Galley was coming through to him too, but it was cut off. They won the faceoff, and it was Hunter that won it. Back to Hatcher. Over over to Galley. Into Hunter, who's come all the way through the slot. And he couldn't have had much room because he didn't lift it off the ice. But he had enough room. And the Capitals lead by one.
Hatcher gets the tying goal and an assist on the one that has broken the tie. Rod Langway is there. Sweeps it away, but Samuelson along to keep play moving. Puck bounced to Poulin. Out to Tocchet, and he finessed one in front, hoping for a bang. It ricocheted off Langway, and then it's thrown quickly back out, but they're denied by Hatcher. Markow to play for Philadelphia. 14:05 to go in the third period. Brian Propp with a wrist shot, blocked away by Peters. Christian can't get it by Tocchet. Fighting for it is Poulin. Behind for Propp. Couldn't tuck it in front on the pass because of Scott Stevens. Propp once more. Had it poked away by Gustafson. Now Poulin tries and is stood up by Hatcher. Every attack met by a check on that ship back deep in the Capital zone. And the clock stopped on the loft out of play. It was a three-game Washington sweep in 1984. This year, they battled 3-3. Through 6 2/3 games, through 40 minutes tonight, the score was 3-3. But now the Capitals have the lead on Hunter's fourth of the playoffs on the power play. Galley and Hatcher assisting at 5:19. Brad Marsh with a shot. He scores! And the game is tied. It may have been on a tip in front. But just that quickly, the big crowd is quieted, and this game is even again.
And what did we say about the foot soldiers? It was Hunter at the other end. And this faceoff, won by the Flyers, right back to Brad Marsh. And he has all kinds of help, because look at the crowd in front of Pete Peters. Does it go off somebody? If it does, it doesn't change directions very much. Brad Marsh just tries to rifle it as hard as he can at the goal. It looks like Peter Zezel. Well, they've given the goal to Marsh. They don't care at this stage of the hockey game. And the seesaw continues. 4-4.
Zezel gets the lone assist at 6:21. The Caps wheel in and battle, and Adams rams into Zezel. And the puck winds up being frozen. So just that quickly, things change, and the Flyers have tied it.
That should tell you how precious these faceoffs are now that are in the zone. Hunter at the other end won the draw on the power play. Ended up scoring the goal on it. Zezel at Pete Peters' end of the ice.
Fistic left winger Greg Adams, at one time a Flyer himself. Then to Hartford. And then in an exchange for tough guy Torrey Robertson, another tough guy Adams came to Washington. Leach, the right winger, along with Adams. And the centerman on this draw is Bobby Gould. Kerr shoveled it so that Howe can play. 13:13 to go in this third period. Hard-fought, scrappy game tonight between these two teams. With it is Gould. Starts back in. Leaned on by Samuelson. Markow takes over. Sidesteps the check of Adams. Cleans it back up the wing where it's set up for Kerr. Kerr recovered with the long reach but spun it to Stevens. Puck taken by Gould. Gould starts ahead. Hit by Howe. Goes back and tests with Samuelson, who uses that body well to wedge him off. Kerr has to have help from Howe, who is leaned on by Leach. 3-on-3 for Philadelphia. Tim Kerr moves in. Had it knocked away by Murphy. Connects with Leach, but it's brushed off him by Eklund. We've had end-to-end in the second and a lot of shots, and now it seems closer. On comes Melendy. Backhander snatched out of the air by Peters. Was about to put it in play, but decides to hold on. Clock stopped with 12:19 to go in the third. Tied at 4. There's an old saying that you try to approach the playoffs hot. Both of these teams won only 3 of their last 13 in the regular season. But what a series performance they have given
in this game tonight and in earlier games, and Bill mentioned at the top of the show, this is a series that has seen so many shifts in control, and a game that has seen that too. Puck back to Marsh. Chipped one that Poulin tries to get to but can't because of Hunter. Puck thrown to Langway. Turns it along to Christian. Dave Christian bringing it back. Watched by Marsh. Hooked at by Brian Propp, and that's enough to throw him off, although he continues to follow up. Still they battle, and Propp able to wheel it back along to Tocchet. Has Poulin breaking. But play breaks down, and it's Hatcher starting back. Took a chop and then a hook from Tocchet. Hatcher shakes one in on goal save. Another attempt at the front of the net. Everyone looking for it. Finally, Tockett's able to clear. Hatcher drills it right back in. It swirls around. Up for Pavonka's shot that is blocked away. Stevens hammers one around that is stopped by the stick of Ron Hextall with 11:30 to go in the third. The Flyers got the first three. The Caps the next four. Then Brad Marsh, who has only four playoff goals, hammered one in to tie the game at four. We have an icing call that brings the faceoff back near Hextall.
Well, since Grant Ledger disappeared with his game misconduct in the first period, that man, Gary Galley, has had to pick up the slack, and it was really Ledger and Galley that picked up a lot of the slack when Rod Langway missed his two games in this series, and Scott Stevens missed a game and part of another one with his shoulder.
In Game 7, Philadelphia has won four. One of the three losses was to Bill Clement and the Calgary Flames in 1981. And only four times in the last decade has a team been down 3-1 and even forced a seventh game before the Caps have done it in this series. That was one of those years. Calgary had the lead 3-1. The Flyers battled back to tie, but then lost at the Spectrum to Calgary in the final game. From the faceoff, it is Howe. Clicks one ahead, off a skate to Sinisalo. Hopes for a winger, but only gets Mike Gartner. Samuelson will give chase with 11:05 to go in the third period of play. Puck spun back along, but through Kelly Miller. Stevens has to rag the puck until his teammates get back outside. Ridley rushes along for Miller. Punched away, and here comes Shel Samuelson, trying to get away from Stevens. Is tumbling to the ice and couldn't get a shot away. Play continues as Ridley misses for Gartner, but to handle it is Kelly Miller. Looks for Gartner, who had appeared an opening. Now plays it to him, but a ricochet, and Gartner must follow up. Wrapped up by the arms of Samuelson. Back up with it comes Sinisalo. Looks for Craven, plays to safety so that the Flyers can change line. Langway connects with Hatcher. Hatcher's pass is on the money to Dale Hunter. Hunter is the man who broke the 3-3 tie. That was earlier in this period. It was followed up a minute and 2 seconds later by Marsh's goal, which put it back in a deadlock again at four. We are halfway through the third period. Marsh rushes, taken by Mellenby. Mellenby stepping further, connects with Eklund, shouldered off by Hatcher. Rod Langway trying to fight away from Mellenby. Shirt pulled from behind, and then Hunter took the hit but got it across, and the Caps are able to play it back down. Boy, they battle for zone, just for a few feet in the zone, just to throw it back down so they can make a change and bring out a fresh line. Here is Mellenby, boom to the board by Hatcher. Puck floated back down, in stride, taking it as Sundstrom, eyed up by Samuelson. Has no one to pass to, so it's given up to Mark Howe. Brought by Derek Smith. Will he go through? No. Bottled up by Sutter. Slipped one in front that ricocheted off Stevens.
Smith had it cocked. He was waiting for it.
Murphy gives back up to Adams. Has Bobby Gould moving, but just a little hook from behind by Ron Sutter was enough to throw that play off. Sutter taps. It's broken up by Steve Leach. But there are just too many Flyers, and so up with it is Derek Smith. Tipping it along to Dave Brown, but he can't get by the checking of Gustafson. Gustafson back. It's gloved away by Crossman. 8:40 to go. Gloved by Brown, then swung back off the shoulder of Murphy. Stevens drive. Caps again make a change. Just one player. Flyers change just one player, too. Brian Propp lays it back out. Stevens is there. Yanks it around to Larry Murphy. Then ahead to Leach.
couldn't feather it to Pavanka because of Howe. Did you see the battling on the boards? Murphy away from Prop. Handcuffed Stevens for a moment, but he's able to get a pass to Leach. Again, the Flyers have changed defenses. Leach fires one that goes wide. To get it is Poulin. Jams it away, and Langway with a shot. Sealed up by Hextall with 7:57 to go in.
You can see the sea of white here at the Cap Center. Score tied at 4. We're down to 7:57 to go. A few moments ago, Big Shell Samuelson had a breakaway. He lumbers over the blue line, and I think that if Don Koharski was going to call a penalty, he had to call it right there. I maintain that Samuelson fell as a result of a trip. He maintained his balance long enough to take at least two stumbles towards the net. But, you know, Koharski let Washington up with one earlier when Murray Craven had a breakaway. On that one, I'm not so sure. To me, there was a trip that took place. Samuelson was just able to maintain balance long enough to prolong the breakaway and let Koharski not make the call.
Gartner just spun one, but answering that one was Hextall. Dumped in by Zezel. Pivoting with it is Galley. Galley rips one off the glass that is taken by Samuelson with 7.5 to go in the third. Gary Galley is back, matched up with Langway on defense. That's an important pair to consider because the two have not played together that often this year. You have a situation, and especially in the series, where Langway missed two games. Ledyard has departed on the night because of a spearing major, which carries an automatic game misconduct. That was in the first period of play. Again, the Flyers drop. Huffman plays it along to Eklund, has to duel with Larry Murphy, couldn't get it through the legs of Ridley, who just pops it back down. This will be an icing call as Crossman is back to touch up. 6:56 to go in the third. Goal scorers Galley, Miller, Hatcher, and Hunter for Washington. Kerr, Prop, Howe, and Brad Marsh for Philadelphia. As you see, the rookie, Kerry Huffman. Exchanging taps with Greg Smith, who now comes on to play defense for the Flyers.
Boy, Mike Keenan has used everybody tonight. Brian Murray has as well. I haven't seen Ivan Korovo very much, but a couple of minutes ago I saw him out here. He played quite a bit in the first period. Boy, you don't know if you have somebody sitting there that might have that little bit of energy left in the legs late in a hockey game, as long as you can hope that he doesn't cost you anything. You take the chance, you put him out there and keep your fingers crossed. Hopefully he does something positive for you, whether it's a Korovo or a Greg Smith.
Capitals at the crossroads. They've been called chokers so often. They have a chance to change that tonight, but this game is deadlocked at 4. Greg Smith kept it in, but turned it loose to Scott Stevens, then on to Hunter. Hunter just deals it in, then takes the hit from Brad Marsh. Puck drilled right along, and Hunter recovered to throw it right in front. It's turned around by Christian, and a sprawling play made by the man who just entered the game, Greg Smith. Loose puck fed wide by Christian. Smith tries to drill it along, and the fans really upset about something. We were following play of the puck, but we see Hunter is without a helmet. Here comes Smith down the wing. Big drive, and that cracked off the glass. It is taken by Gustafson. Leads it ahead to Scott Stevens. Stevens tried to bank one across and then feeds one in front that's swept away by Kerr. Incredible action and a toss to the front, knocked away. Gustafson finesses it behind to Christian. Back for Gustafson, picked off by Tim Kerr. They scrap for it, and the puck frozen for a stoppage of play. One tick of the clock under 6 minutes to go in the third. And back at the other end, Pete Peters is laboring.
Sure is. You don't usually bob back and forth like that when you have an equipment problem. The last rush saw Greg Smith come down and rifle one that I think was deflected, perhaps, Mike, high and wide. And when you have a defenseman that's up on the play and the puck doesn't end up on goal, for whatever reason, very often you're vulnerable going the other way. That's how the Caps ended up with that rush coming back the other way. So Pete Peters is having some kind of difficulty. You know, you can only speculate, but I wonder if there might be something to do with the leg cramp at this stage of the hockey game. Tough to say.
One of the things that has happened to Pete in the past, and again, it might be unfair to mention it, but just to bring you up on history, he has had to leave games this season with cramps. Boy, they've both had some tough ones, haven't they?
You bet.
Man, oh, man. In case you're just joining us, the game is tied at 4. The series tied at 3. The winner of this game tonight will host games 1 and 2 against the New Jersey Devils. Maybe we can get a look here. Oh, I see. Okay, Hunter was taken down there. We thought for a moment that we were going to see the Greg Smith rush. But Rod Langway was eyeball to eyeball with Koharski when play was stopped to protest that there had been no penalty.
Well, did you see how the stick was lying on the ice, too? Dale Hunter got tangled up. Whether Brad Marsh intentionally put his stick in between his legs, we'll never know. We didn't even get a good look at it. But Marsh did the smart thing by letting his stick go immediately so that if Hunter did go down, he wouldn't be hanging onto the stick real close to him. Hunter spilled, lost his helmet. There was no call. You can see Mike Keenan. Boy, there are some decibels coming out of his mouth. He might not be using his arms and ranting and raving, walking back and forth, but you can tell that he is speaking decisively back there to his guys, as you know Brian Murray is as well. What a weight can be lifted off of Brian Murray's shoulders, and a weight as well off Mike Keenan's shoulders. He has had, I'm sure, one of the most up and down seasons that he has ever had. The Flyers faltered so terribly early, then came on to the longest winning streak in the NHL. Up and down, injuries throughout March. At one time, Mark Howe was hurt, so was Kerry Huffman, Eklund, Tim Kerr, Ron Sutter, Berube, Poulin, Brown, Tocchet, Sinisalo. The list goes on. Zezel, Ronnie Hextall, Craven, also Willie Huber. So that's the kind of march that Mike Keenan has had, and he and Brian Murray go back a long way. They've locked horns for the Canadian Memorial Cup Championship. That goes to the junior team that is supreme in Canada. Murray was in Regina, and Mike Keenan was in Peterborough. Then they coached against each other in the American League. So once again, they find themselves down to the short strokes against one another.
Here is Tocchet with a drive that was slowed by Langway. Hatcher drills it back around. Sundstrom trying to tap it through. Howe can't do it. Hatcher flips. Howe able to keep. Couldn't step by Sundstrom. Lays it ahead to Kelly Miller. Miller with a duel, and Shel Samuelson comes up with it. Tocchet starts it back ahead. And Poulin on his left. Kropp on his right. Shovels to Poulin. Poulin just fires one that's well off the mark. Kropp able to chase it down because Samuelson took care of Miller. Flyers must regroup. Mark Howe back with 5 minutes, 15 seconds to go in regulation time. If they're still tied, a full 15-minute intermission followed by the first of what can be a number of sudden-death overtime periods. Kropp puts that one into the glove of Pete Peters. Washington with 27 shots in this game, and the Flyers with 29. Here is Guttner trying to flip one, but it was tipped by Crosman, and then was he ever hammered from behind by Greg Adams. Loose puck to the front, turned aside by Hextall. Spun to Murphy, can't hold. Ridley decides to move in himself. Feeds it over to Stevens. Pivots from one. A shot trapped and held by Ron Hextall after that one sailed through a screen. Remarkable with 4:34 to go in the third. Another save. It looks so easy from up here, doesn't it? But it had to go through a sea of arms and legs.
Stevens stick handled his way into the slot and got outstanding wood on that shot. Here he comes, and down goes Hextall. You could see that Mike Gartner was standing there right on his doorstep, so Hextall was going down. If there was a rebound, he wanted to be able to get close to it. Just before that, Mike Ridley was taken down by Rick Tocchet. And then Adams crushed into one of the Flyers behind the net. It's all for keeps out there now.
On Koharski explaining something to Adams, who turns away. Every faceoff so significant, and Gustafson will be the man Brian Murray will count on for this one. Peter Zezel will represent the Flyers. Christian and Pavonka are the wingers for Gustafson. Stevens and Murphy are in back. And it'll be Brad Marsh working the back line for Philadelphia along with Doug Crosman. Even close in that category, isn't it? There were only 10 total shots in the first period. 34 total shots in the second. Such a change. Ron Finn, the veteran linesman. Visitors stick down first, then the home team. Zezels is down, and then Gustafson's. Kicked back to Stevens. Drive blocked off by Hextall. Doug Crosman banks it out. Riding for it is Cinesalo. The trailer is Craven. Cinesalo to Craven, and it went through him. Zezel hurries one in front. Blocked off by Christian. Drive by Zezel. Tipped just wide of the post. Man, oh, man. Crossman drops it back along. Delayed offside. Flyers clear. So do the Capitals, and so there'll be no whistle. Christian hit by Mars. Gustafson follows it up. Checked by Zezel. Strides back after it, though. To Stevens. A drive went through the crease wide. Murphy keeps. Wrist the prayer.
Have a problem. Zezel doesn't have a stick. He is a key guy back there. They need a stoppage, and they don't get it yet.
A drive by Christian popped over the goal. And we get the stoppage of play on a hand pass, and that gives Zezel a chance to get his stick. And us, our composure with 3:45 to go in the third, tied at four. Dale Hunter and Ron Sutter will test their face-off skills. So many face-offs these guys take in the course of a year. Everyone's so significant. We're late in the third with 3:45 to go. Who will get this one? Little battle. Samuelson just coasts in, and along with him comes Sundstrom. Now it's dropped and controlled by Sutter. Sutter flips one that misses for Mellenby and goes down. There'll be no icing. Mellenby goes charging back, gets away from Langway. Mellenby centered one, but that one ricocheted back. Tries again and spins one that's tipped wide by Dave Poulin. Samuelson with a shot that's dubbed. He and Sundstrom locked up. So it's Mellenby pivoting for Philadelphia. Put it right back into the cluster of players. Dale Hunter spins one back across to Gould. Ekstall plays the carom. Walks it back around to Mark Howe. Howe tosses. Patcher can't chip it back in. Second effort, though, he's unable to do it. And another chance for Washington, as taking this is Samuelson. Misses for Smith, and the puck hopped off Patcher. Patcher and Stevens the defense. Miller, Ridley, and Gould up front. Bobby Gould has had two shorthanded goals in this series, one each in the last two games. Moves it in deep. Tested there by Brad Marsh. Kerr comes in as well. Gould trying to kick it along, but Kerr able to reach it and fend it back up to Derek Smith. Eklund lays it for Smith, but Kelly Miller got there first. That play breaks down. Miller tries to stagger ahead. Goes down, and the fans upset as in comes Eklund. One-on-one, and Larry Murphy just flicked it away. Kelly Miller checking back up the wing. Hands it on to Ridley. Crosses with Gartner. Mike Ridley slams one. Blocked off by a kneeling Brad Marsh, and he's hurt. Murphy with a shot. Scooped up by Hextall. And Hextall was told to get the glove down on it because Marsh was injured. And so that's what he did. And Marsh will limp around and try to shake this one off.
Somebody had to be yelling on Brad Marsh's behalf. He went down to block the shot and caught it somewhere where he didn't have any equipment. Watch Ridley cross the blue line here. His teammates did a real good job of staying onside. Marsh made a great play making the block, but he is stunned, at least momentarily. Usually the pain goes away. Sometimes you end up with a broken bone, but there he goes. He might have gotten it in the ankle. Puck ends up coming to Hextall. The Flyers were able to freeze it, but the one negative is they end up deep in their zone for another faceoff. Washington has been pretty strong on them tonight, especially Gustafson, and he's the man that's out there now.
Flyers will use Murray Craven. Stevens pulls in close to the faceoff circle. As you see, the important figures in this one. Most of you who follow hockey know that Game 7 is the last one that teams play in a series if it's forced that far. Washington has done it, being down at one time in this series, 3-1. But winning here in Game 5, 6-2, and then in Game 6 at the Spectrum two nights ago, 7-2. It all has come to this. Puck one back for Stevens, but he's got to regather out of the attack zone. Brushed back along by Pavanka to get it, though, is Dave Poulin. Poulin just slides it to Samuelson. Under 2 minutes to play. The pass goes under Craven. Larry Murphy hammers one back in. Hextall whips it along, hoping for Poulin. Gets it to him. Flyers start out. They hurry it up, and it's Tocchet handing on to Brian Propp. Good play by Murphy, but Propp recovers to poke it through, and Stevens was right there to read the play for Washington. Stevens' pass is out to Pavanka, moving up with Gustafson. Pavanka chased off by Howe. This is Brian Propp. Ahead now to Tockett. Tockett twists to the boards and glass, and a good hard check by Hatcher. 1 minute, 20 seconds to go in the third period. Hatcher pivots away from Poulin, then meets up with Propp and lays a little pass to Gustafson. Slides it across to Langway. Then ahead to Christian. Christian dumps it. Crossman goes back. Rattles the boards to Propp. Loses, though, and a toss to the front. Knocked away from Sundstrom. Langway steers it across. Shot is saved. Rebound is poked wide. The first shot by Gartner. The rebound by Sundstrom. Hatcher at the point. Tries to get away from the checking of Poulin. Taken down. Hunter in front. Cross ice. Gartner drilled it wide. 45 seconds to go. Fans upset that there was no penalty. As Sundstrom chops at it. It's knocked away. Turning with it, Sundstrom. Flips one in front. Loose puck. Everyone looking for it. Where is it? Is stopped with 38 seconds to go.
Well, everybody here sure thought that there was going to be a penalty called on Brian Propp. He made a good defensive play at the blue line. Hatcher went around him. Wow. And then Propp wrapped his arms around him right here on the right of your screen. There it is. Drags down Kevin Hatcher. But the Caps had other scoring chances. Mike Gardner shot the puck a million miles an hour wide of the net right there. That was gone around the back of the net before Hextall had a chance to react to it.
We've made mention during the course of these playoffs that officials have tended to be tight in the first, second, third, and in overtime. And this has been a rare exception, although this shifts our minds back to last year when there was a crucial game seven that wound up going into overtime, and things were allowed to go because at that time everybody knew what the situation was and the referee was not going to take it upon himself to decide the contest. They talk it over at the bench. Sutter, Poulin, Howe, and Craven. I'm sure the Caps' focus is so tight that they don't think of what we're thinking about 1 year ago when there was another do-or-die game for Washington that took so long to play. We'll tell you that sudden death overtime looms 38 seconds away. Full-scale intermission. Tom Meese will be put back to work in Bristol. Tom on the edge of his chair, as we imagine many of you are in watching this thriller. Three goals for Philadelphia, followed by four for Washington, and then Brad Marsh tying the game at 6:21, elapsed time in this period. It is now 19:22, 38 seconds of regulation time to go, and again, Bent Gustafson will have to take the faceoff with Murray Craven. Craven just sort of posted around a moment ago, did you notice, and looked up toward the ceiling, perhaps getting his focus and his composure together for this important draw. Again, encroachment by Sutter and Miller this time. Out of the suspense, here it comes. Craven and Gustafson wins it back to Hatcher. Big drive, one wide! Over to Sutter with half a minute to go. Can't clear out. Kept in by Stevens to Gartner, who shoveled it wide. Pivoting to get it is Craven. Has a man ahead, Dave Poulin. 25 seconds to go. The winger now is Howe. And Howe with a shot. Passed up Peters. Rebound poked away. Poulin centers one. And it goes all the way back to neutral ice. The Flyers must regroup. They have a dozen seconds as they play it into Stevens. Hit pass. Sails by Gartner. There'll be no icing call. 5 seconds away is sudden death overtime. You hear them chant it down. It'll take more than seven full games to determine a winner.
15-minute intermission.
Well, are they cheering overtime? This game looked as if it was out of Brian Murray's hands early, with the Flyers running away with it. Three goals in the first period. Maybe this organization does have the character that I mentioned really hasn't been revealed in their history. The Capitals have battled back, then the Flyers had to come back. And I guess it's only fitting that we end up going into overtime in this, the seventh game of the Patrick Division semifinals between these two teams. What will happen? It's absolutely anybody's guess. Pete Peters wrong when he's had to be. So is Ron Hextall. More to come.
Where we stood for the remainder of the third period. That goal by Marsh came with 6:21 gone in the third, and we're still tied at four. Stanley Cup, 7th overtime, Game 7, Patrick Division semifinals. We're set for action now. Here's Mike Emmerich and Bill Clement.
Thank you, Tom. The goaltenders have been such a key to not only this series, but this game. Let's look at some numbers.
Here's what the Warriors have done tonight. They have faced 32 for Hextall and 30 for Peters. Four from out far, from back at the blue line. The tough saves, just about 50% for both of them. Hextall has handled the puck far more than Pete Peters. He wanders more, but you know what? His up-ice moves, really, 11 is not a big number of up-ice moves. To me, that tells you that Ron Hextall has pulled back and tried to play within himself a little more tonight, possibly given the fact that he came into this game a little bit on shaky ground. Really hasn't had his best performances in games 5 and 6, but it's been there when he's had to be tonight. Here's a look at the scoring.
Two gritty performers. Hunter broke the tie. Marsh lopped it up again. This is the seventh sudden death overtime game for Pete Peters. He had two wins with Boston, two losses during his stay with Philadelphia, and had two losses as a Washington Capital, both of those in 86 to the Rangers. It's the third overtime game for Ron Hextall. He won in game one against Montreal last year and lost in game two in the finals against Edmonton, and a shot went off the trapper of Pete Peters from Howe.
He thought he had that one and he didn't.
In the first 4 seconds of sudden death, nearly sudden death, Langway checked by Dave Poulin. Starting away with it is Pavanka. It's a 3-on-2. Pavanka with Gustafson on his left. But the play was offside going in, so it couldn't be worked to the right to Christian.
Boy, he was ready for it, wasn't he? I always wonder, why doesn't it go to the man that's ahead, especially in overtime? You know, back checkers are coming as fast as they can. Pavanka decided to, well, I'll just get across the blue line and then make a play over to Dave Christian. But if I'm in overtime, I know I want Dave Christian to have it. If I'm playing center, he has scored some huge goals in his career.
Ryan Murray saw the justice in game six, that Christian, who had been so involved in the previous games, did not have a goal to show for it. But in game six, he got one. Peter Zezel on the faceoff with Ridley. And it is one back. Marsh to take it. We are in sudden death overtime at Capital Center in Landover, Maryland. The puck comes to Gartner. Gartner fires one off the stick of Hextall. Pinching is Stevens. Can he keep play moving? It rolls along to Ridley. Wrapped up by Samuelson. Converging on that one is Marsh, and he scales it out of play. 47 seconds into period four. We'll talk with Brad Marsh. I wonder what part of the stick. Was it the shaft that it got on that one?
I think it hit the handle of his stick above his hand.
It's happened a lot to both these teams. A great deal has been said about the Capitals when they've had their backs to the wall. But it's been that way for the last four nights. They won not only game five, but six. Ridley again poised for the draw with Craven. Trying to get loose for the backhander is Gartner, but wedged off by Howe. Shell Samuelson ahead. Up the wing. It's Craven with a shot off the stick of Pete Peters. Miller booms into Samuelson. They continue to work, and the pass goes back to Zezel, who flopped one wide. Reaching for it, Craven, but there first was Larry Murphy. And the puck scaled back ahead, and Gartner's trying to pull loose. He's taken down on the play. There'll be a penalty coming up. And a power play in sudden death overtime for the Washington Capitals.
It had to be done. And it had to be done by Mark Howe. What a guy that they don't want going off right now. He is obviously their key back there. So Mark Howe ends up having to hook Mike Gardner here. Now Gardner will go down to make it look worse than it is, but there is Gardner pulling away. He finally says, hey, listen, I'm getting cut off anyway. I'm going to go down. tough play by Mark Howe and a tough call because Hextall is out. Watch the left of your screen. There's Hextall. Now, does he get to the puck first if Mark Howe lets him go? Howe couldn't take the chance. Pulled him down. Don Koharski makes the call. Getting pretty tense.
This is the eighth time in this playoff round that a team has had a power play in sudden death overtime. In this series, it's the first time. Gustafson, Christian, and Pavanka. The hot tickets are out right now for the Capitals. Murphy to Stevens. Over to Christian, and he fired it wide. Rebound, ricocheted, off escape, punched away, centering pass, save made by the sprawling Samuelson. Another shot, and that one blocked away by Hextall. Christian with two 10-bell chances. Now working for another as he hands to Stevens. And then over to Murphy. Across to Dave Christian again. Centers one off the side of the net. Loose puck and banging into Hextall was a Capital, but he had the puck held and a stoppage of play. Man, oh man, did Christian have two good opportunities.
He sure did. And Kjell Samuelson may have just saved the season for the Philadelphia Flyers. Obviously, they'd have to pull it out. Well, he sure saved the season for them with one stop on Christian. Hextall held his ground right at the end. The puck ended up lodged right against the post. Look at this pass right through. Samuelson deflects it to Christian and then makes the save himself. He goes down and blocks. I think Hextall got the second save.
A minute 34 to go on the power play. All that furious action and only 26 seconds have gone off the penalty clock. The winner of this plays New Jersey on the winner's home ice beginning Monday. Sam Rosen and Phil Esposito will have that one for you. We'll open things up out west, Calgary and Edmonton on Tuesday at the Saddle Dome in Calgary. But right now, the focus on this big one. Gustafson on the draw. Stevens, a drive, his stick shatters, and the puck kicks back to Murphy. Hurries it along, hoping for Pavanka. Wedged off by Marsh, who's able to fish it away, but back now for Murphy's shot, and it went off the glass. Capitals recover back in their own zone. Scott Stevens will just take it all the way behind. A minute 15 to go on this power play. Teams tied at four in period number four of game seven. The Flyers make the Capitals chase it again. Tockett, Samuelson, Marsh, and Sutter are the four for Philadelphia. Pavanka gives to Larry Murphy. Murphy strips one back now for a shot by Christian. Backhander by Pavanka, poked in the air by Samuelson, and fanning on one was Hextall, but Marsh helped out. Sutter sends it back down, and Pete Peters is waiting. Nearly gave it up to Sutter. Back up now comes Ridley. Poked away by Samuelson, but Ridley follows up to Hatcher. Hatcher as Christian tried to shake loose in front. Lost the puck to the checking of Tockett, and again the Capitals have to go back. 25 seconds to go, power play. Stevens takes a look to Ridley. Carries it along himself. Down he goes on the hook, beats to Ridley in front. Gardner hit the post, scramble in front. They hit the glass with a shot. Incredible! And the puck turned back out. And here is Brian Propp on a breakaway. Save! Another shot. Save made on the play by Peters. Man, oh man, oh man.
Where do you want to start? Point me in the right direction. Where do you want to start with these replays? Prop after the post by Gardner is stymied by Pete Peters. The rebound goes right back to Prop, and it looks like Peters has it in his glove. He has it in his trapper. And at the other end, Ridley back to Gardner. Ding dong right off the post. The rebound, oh, right over Hunter's stick. Gardner ends up face first on the ice.
I don't know how much either man slept last night. I don't know the effects of pressure on them, the pressure of a seventh game. Well, but are they ever showing skills in the goal tonight? And a little bit of luck, like that shot on the post, sure doesn't hurt much either.
Do we have to be here? Do we just take our headsets off and watch this? I mean, this is taking care of itself. And you know that the Devils are sitting home. Jim Schoenfeld, I know you guys are watching, saying, hey, boys, play all night. Play till Sunday at noon. We'll just sit here and relax and cleanse our rooms.
Hunter loses, tipped by Howe. Hunter with a second effort, puck chipped back out again by Brad Marsh. Teams are back at full strength. Through all of that lunacy, the Flyers were able to kill off the power play. Marsh floats it back to Howe. A pass tipped by Tim Kerr. Lays it ahead, but too far for Eklund. Pete Peters out to swing it along. Kerr tried to step by. It's held by Crossman, but outside the line, and so offside is called.
A minute and 1 second. Three shots. That doesn't include the one off the post by Mike Gardner. Man, you got to like the Devils' chances in game one sitting at home. We've talked during this playoffs of how big an advantage it would be, especially in the Packer division, because the games have been so tough, of winning a series in fewer than seven games. Well, there were only two series in the Packer division. The Devils got by the Islanders in six. Keep in mind, Monday night is when the teams will go at it for the Packer division championship. One of these two teams and the Devils, in those precious days that the Devils are having right now to sit back and relax a little bit.
You saw the remarkable calm of Brian Murray. One of his players, Kevin Hatcher, lays it back into Philadelphia territory. Shel Samuelson, who has made some big blocks in sudden death overtime, saw one blocked that time by Rod Langway. It is blasted by Hatcher, kicks to Langway, able to thread it through, and up the wing comes Gardner with another chance. Gardner over for Holmstrom, and a strong save made by Hextall.
What a save.
Ridley watched by Howe. Along now to Gardner. Locked up by Samuelson. Sundstrom pops one. It hops over the glass and into the seats. And Hextall has robbed Sundstrom. And Mike Gardner must be checking his legs for snake bite, the type of opportunities he's been involved in.
There's no question that Hextall knows he's in this type of situation. Well, I say that, he didn't react to it. I'm saying to myself, Hextall had to read or at least feel the pass coming. But he doesn't even move. Watch Hextall and time when he moves. There goes the pass. Only then does he move, and does he move? He moves perfectly. If Sundstrom gets it up a little higher, he gets it over him. Sundstrom did make the right play by getting it up. He just didn't get it up high enough. What a save. Perfect feed by Gardner, who'd gone wide on Mark Howe. Well, it's, you know, Tom mentioned deja vu, and you sit here saying, well, come on. I mean, last year was a different time. Sure, we're in overtime 1 year later. But remember the saves that Mason and Kelly Rudy made in that hockey game? Peters has robbed Brian Propp twice, once in the original shot, once in his own rebound. Hextall, well, you just saw what he did.
37 shots by Washington, 33 by Philadelphia. It could be the next one, or we could be a long ways off. Melody with a shove on Pavanka. Meanwhile, Murray Craven, about to take this draw, goes for a little bit of skate. Capitals with the edge in that department. Number of interest, but right now the next one could be the biggest one of the night. Stevens has pulled back in and gets it from the faceoff. Shoveled, but already having dropped back was Gary Galley. And Galley hammers it back in and caught a couple of men in the zone.
Somebody might be saying, well, why was Galley not up there? Anytime Scott Stevens goes in like that, this is overtime. You got to play safe. You got to back out. Scott Stevens, I think, was hoping for something that was unrealistic, for Gary Galley to hold his ground while he's trying to stick handle by people.
Normally, Stevens is out there with Larry Murphy. And right now, they're just checking on their communications just then. Galley, of course, wants to play it safe.
Boy, did you see Shel Samuelson's mouth? Blood streaming out of it. When you walk into a locker room at this time of a hockey season, you see cuts, abrasions, stitches, ice packs, ace bandages. And it's a wonder that some of these guys can make it to the ice surface. But night after night, they do. And they play through it all. They play with blood streaming out of open cuts on their faces. When you get to be in a situation like this with overtime, you wait to get stitched up until later.
Markow take from Hextall. Glides ahead. Hands to Poulin. Connects with Tim Kerr. Kerr with a shot that ricocheted off Scott Stevens. Peters leaves, and it is thrown around by Murphy. Taken by Dave Christian. Christian with two of the better chances in sudden death overtime. Pavanka throws one off the glove of Hextall. It pops away. Pavanka booming back in along with Gustafson there. Thrown in front by Christian, and the puck came across the goal mouth. Stevens a shot! And that one held by a crumbling Hextall. 14:47 to go in sudden
You know, I think the coolest player I've ever seen in overtime might be Gustafson. This is him along the boards. He sized up Dave Poulin. Gustafson uses his body so well. He waited till the last second to lean into Poulin. That's how he freed the puck up, got it through. All the way through. There's Michael Pavanka, who'd been taken down in front by Samuelson. And Stevens pinched in, as he's done so many times tonight, and rifled one right into the midsection of Ron Hextall. But Gustafson is so cool out there. He doesn't waste an ounce of energy.
He'll get his energy recharged as he comes to the bench now. Some of you might be joining us on ESPN right now, anticipating the scheduled program, which was a truck pull tonight. Because of the length of the game, that will be canceled. But stay with us. If you've never seen a hockey game before, you're catching on to one of the finest that we've seen in quite some time.
The hockey pull.
Boy, is it ever. Best of seven. The two teams are tied. They forced a seventh game. They were tied through 60 minutes. We took a full-fledged intermission, and now we're playing the first sudden-death overtime. It can go a lot longer than that. Stay with us for this. Off the faceoff, Bobby Gould goes after it. Flips one through Howe. Samuelson takes his man. Hunter centers, backhander answered by Hextall as he kicked off a Bobby Gould shot. Puck laid back in by Poulin. Tapped away by Stevenson. Murphy hustles to play. Locked up by Sinisalo. Craven comes in as well. Better chances in the overtime have been Philadelphia's. Bobby Gould hoping to generate another one. Starts ahead with Hunter pulling up on the right. Wrist one, stick save made by Hextall. And the rebound grabbed back up now by Murray Craven. Craven denied at the line. Has to follow up and gives up to Larry Murphy. Breaking is Hunter. He's by the defense.
More 10 bell save to keep this game alive, and he came very close to it, but on a breakaway right up the middle, the man that has the heart, well, just about as big as this Capitol Center, Dale Hunter, puts it by Ron Hextall, and there you see Pete Peters congratulating and obviously distraught Ron Hextall. And there is Mike Gardner, who was stymied so many times in this series by Ron Hextall. But the Washington Capitals, to their credit, have hung in and hung in all the way to what we have right now. The ceremonial handshake, which will send the Washington Capitals Monday night in the Patriot Division Finals on to meet the New Jersey Devils. Gallant effort by both teams.
Sweeps of Philadelphia in 84 and the Islanders in 86 have been long forgotten here. What these fans, some of whom wore black armbands before Game 5, recall is going up 2-0 in a best of five with the Islanders in 85 and going out three straight. Being up 2-1 in a best of seven with the Rangers in 86 and going out three straight. Being up 3-1 on the Islanders last year and going out three straight. This year, they were the ones down. They gave away the fourth game. They led 4-1 in the last 9 minutes. Remember that? Lost in overtime, but they came back.
They out-hit the Flyers in Game 5 and humiliated Philadelphia in the Spectrum 7-2 two nights ago. And tonight, before a full house of fans who are ready to resume their cynicism or thrill to a comeback based on one score of one game, there it is. Capitals 5, Flyers 4. Who do you pick as Hartford Insurance Player of the Game?
Well, it didn't really matter what he did during the game, and it wouldn't have mattered. We knew whoever was going to score the overtime goal would be our Hartford Insurance Player of the Game. Dale Hunter, number 32 of the Washington Capitals, is in fact the Hartford Insurance Player of the Game. Because of his overtime goal here at the Cav Center, we will be showing you more of Capitals hockey and the proud Flyers in their season. We were with them all the way to the Stanley Cup Finals in the seventh game last year. It just was not in the cards for the Flyers this year.
The guy who scored the overtime goal, Dale Hunter.
Question mark turns to an exclamation point here in Landover. Let's go back to Tommy.
All right, Mike Emmerich, thank you very much. Our 7-up play of the night, there can also be no doubt about it. The series winning goal, Dale Hunter gets by the Flyer defense. Hextall gets a piece of it, but it wasn't enough. Dale Hunter, his fourth sudden death overtime winner in his career. The Capitals beat the Flyers on the play of the night.